This is Happy Jack's RPG podcast. This is an actual play. It's the very, very, very beginning of an actual play. This is the sort of thing that I usually don't want to record because I think it's usually kind of boring. But everyone else wants to. So we're going to do it. I think character generation is a great, fun thing, but I don't know. People watch it, I guess. I don't know.
Everyone character generation, specifically in this system,
it is
worthwhile.
I think. Best character generation ever.
I think.
Yes.
Because character generation in a lot of other games...
super boring.
Would not be that exciting. No. But in this one, there's the whole, like, you get to watch for connections.
Right.
And you get to announce what horrible things have happened to you.
That's true. I agree.
And or you end up with Social 12.
And not only that, with the second edition of Mongoose Traveller, mm-hmm. we are now sitting on the best character generation system that has now been improved.
Yeah. I'm shocked and amazed.
It is. It's fantastic. So, now, let me talk a little bit about the game. I want to run a low-tech game. We figured out it was TL10,
yeah.
which is early Stellar, according to the Traveller rules. So we're talking. The game is going to take place about probably like 40 or 50 years after the invention of the jump drive.
Okay.
So I can go through the timeline real quick if you guys want to hear it, because I've started with. This is not going to be in the Third Imperium setting or timeline in any way.
That's good. There's a lot of information with that, and.
And we don't need it.
Yeah, it's imposing, yeah.
Who are we first, though?
Oh, yeah. My name is Stu. I will be GMing the game when it gets ready to start.
My name is Kimmy, and I'll be playing in the game. I have no idea who yet because we haven't made the characters.
It's about to happen.
It's so exciting.
And I'm Kadave, and I'm playing something interesting.
It'll be great.
I hope.
Promise.
And we're going to have more players as well, because I'm thinking about running this game as the Sunday game when Vampire can't happen, which is most Sundays, it turns out.
Yeah, it seems that way.
We're playing about once every 3 to 4 weeks right now, the Vampire game, so it'd be nice to have something...
Killing me, guys. Killing me.
A little more regular.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm also going to make a character, just kind of for shits and giggles.
Okay.
It could end up being an NPC.
It could end be, or it could be a character that someone else picks up if mm-hmm. they're not a regular part of it, but they want to play in the game.
Cool.
So, in 2059, the first manned mission to Mars. Long-term stay there was possible because of massive supply shipments sent prior to the manned mission. Several other missions sent, as well as a few return missions. 2084, construction of a permanent habitat facility on Mars begins. This is a joint effort between NASA, European Space Administration, or Space Agency, and Roscosmos, which I guess is the name of the Russian space agency, yeah. which I had to look up. Later this year, an agreement is reached with the Chinese National Space Agency to join the effort as well. 2098, first civilian colonists arrive at Mars habitat, which is now called Rosetta Base. 2105, Chinese physicist Zhang An develops first design for sustainable, efficient fusion reactor. Her discoveries are classified by the Chinese government as state secrets. She resists these efforts and attempts to go public with her discovery. She is eventually jailed and executed for espionage. But her design eventually gets out, causing a shockwave of reorganization to the world's economies. Her discovery touches off worldwide unrest that is eventually called the Energy Wars. 2107, the world is still in a state of civil disorder. Massive migrations have occurred as oil-rich regions of the world become hotbeds of warfare and unrest. Legal battles in the United States stall the adoption of the AN reaction plant, which is what they call those drives.
The fusion reactor.
The ARPs, for several years. 2 years later, 2109, smaller versions of ARPs are fitted into newer spacecraft, allowing for ships with greater range and eventually the ability to refuel using trace gases in space and ultimately, many years down the line, Jupiter's atmosphere. 2118, first manned mission to Jupiter. departs. This is a joint venture between the Chinese National Space Agency and the European Space Agency. 2120, scientific data from Jupiter returns. Several mineral-rich moons reported. Many nations examine the feasibility of mounting Jupiter mining missions. Several nations now fly multiple missions to Mars as the civilian population exceeds the state employee populations. That is, the government workers are now the minority on Mars. Several private contractors received charters from the United Nations to begin building habitats on Mars. Murmurings of Martian independence and UN representation meet with resistance and vetoes from the Security Council nations. 2125. Dr. Carl Iliopoulos, because I knew a guy in high school named Iliopoulos. That's why I did that.
Really?
Yes.
Awesome.
There were several Greeks that went to my high school. Designs a sustainable micro ecosystem that can fit in a very large spacecraft, allowing for the population of several hundred to survive for generations. The era of generation ships begins. Mm. In the next two centuries, colonization of the solar system continues. This is kind of a fast forward. Other planets are dotted with habitats, as well as several Jovian moons and Luna. Political division continues along the lines of the EU, USA, Russia, and China, proved to be the major players in space colonization. Earth's population stabilizes, and ecological damages begin to lessen due to an end to fossil fuel consumption. United Nations still not representing extraterrestrial colonies as independent states. Several agreements between colonies and their founding nations stem political unrest. Most colonies given quote-unquote economic independence, meaning that their respective populations reap the benefits from their resources. There is still much lawlessness outside of Earth. 2240, we're now 200 years ahead, a little over 200 years. Incredibly faint messages from generation ships begin arriving. Some appear to report all well. Others report disappointment with habitability of planets in their systems. In all, 50 or so generation ships were sent out. Only a handful report anything about arrival. Scientists believe many of these messages are just too faint to detect above the background noise. And then in 2332, which is about another 100 years later, Boris Kramnik develops what will become the first jump drive, allowing a vessel to travel within a pocket universe and emerge great distances away in our universe. That's what I have so far. Now, what I'm thinking is the game is going to be low tech for travelers, so it'd be the tech level 10. You have jump one ships. So if you're trying to get to a star that's two or three parsecs away, someone has put either you have fuel tanks to be able to carry enough fuel that way, which may or may not be feasible at tech level 10. I'm not sure.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think it is. Mm-hmm. So there's probably someone has established in deep space depots, like fuel depots.
Sure.
So you'll make a jump one, refuel, make another jump one, refuel, make another one, and you've traveled three parsecs. It would take you almost a month to do that, but,
sure. But you can still doable.
Do it. It's doable. So there are no ships faster than jump one. That you know of. And there's no, and really there's no technology above TL-10. Now, one of the problems that I've noticed with Traveller, I won't say one of the problems, the most, Traveller gives you like three different kinds of games to run. There's the merchant game, which is you are a merchant vessel. You're going to go to this planet, you're going to buy something, you're going to take it to this planet and hopefully sell it for more than you paid for it. Mm-hmm. And you do this over and over again, it becomes like spreadsheets and scimitars.
Sure.
Then there's the military campaign. Military campaign, you go out and you do missions. You go out and you shoot stuff or you liaise or do whatever it is you're going to do. Problem with any military campaign is there's a
hierarchy.
There's a chain of command. People within the party might have different spots in that chain of command, which is fine, but then also there's usually someone higher up in the chain of command who is an NPC who tells you what to do. So I don't want to do that. And I don't remember what the third one is. The Explorer campaign, which is go to different planets, find a new thing. It's Star Trek, basically, right?
Yeah.
Which is, for me, a huge workload. Trying to come up with, what's the next planet? We're going to skip this one and go to the next one. That's great. Right, so what I would like to try to come up with...
Whatever you prep for that planet is the next planet we stop at.
Oh, these See? People are blue too.
Oh,
it's so
amazing.
Weird. And they have like little puffy tails, just like the people on the other planet.
Mm-hmm.
But they're different.
But you never stopped at that other planet, so you don't know.
That's true.
These are, instead of being called Smurfs, these are Smorfs. Anyway, so what I'd like to try to come up with is what kind of adventure or what kind of game we want to run, because that I think can be decided independent of the characters.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we can, before we start.
Yeah. So, but I don't really want to run something where there's a lot of spreadsheets and we have to worry about, oh, you pick up this and get credits for that, and then the profit is this, and your ship costs this much. And no.
That's why we're playing Edge of the Empire, or Empire's Twilight, evidently.
That's, right. That is in some, not as bad.
Not as badly not as it would be in Traveller, but
no. And I don't want to have to have it be a military game, because I want the party to be able to do what the party wants to do, not. Although it could,
you could kind of blend the military with the exploration.
Mm-hmm.
Okay,
we could kind of go with we are all loosely affiliated with having a letter of marque.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay, all right.
Like, as humanity is expanding out into the universe for the first time, really,
mm-hmm.
there's going to be colonies that we find from those generation ships.
Absolutely, yeah.
In places that we don't expect. There's going to be stuff like that. But you're also so far away with no reasonable way to communicate back to Earth instantly.
Mm-hmm. Correct.
That there's going to be privateers, almost. That, like, we're a crew that, you know, like, we might take down our IFF and put up the skull and crossbones. You know, like, that's something we could totally do.
Okay.
And reasonably feel like we could get away with that.
Yeah.
Sometimes.
I agree.
But we could be affiliated with a nation state or another mm-hmm. or whatever.
I'm assuming at this point, there's still, on Earth, you still have the four superpowers, if you want to call them.
Mm-hmm.
And as far as what's beyond Earth, I haven't decided anything yet. I mean, I have a couple ideas in the back of my head, but I haven't really decided anything yet. I can do that kind of as I know what kind of characters we're going to have. Mm-hmm. So that's basically...
Are we all starting as born on Earth?
I would say yes. Or you could, not necessarily, could be...
Born in our solar system.
Born in the solar system.
Okay.
And I'm going to make a character too.
Okay.
Okay.
So you got the... I don't need a sheet yet. I'm going to use paper for now.
Okay, well...
Because I don't want to...
Thank you.
I'll hand you one anyway, and you can have it. Because it has a nice list of skills on there when you.
Oh, it does have a nice
part.
List of skills. What did I do? Oh, there's my dice. Okay, so character generation. I don't see my chart. In the new Traveller, they give you a little flow chart. A little flow chart right there.
And it's super nice.
It gives you everything. So where do you start? Creating a Traveller, you roll your statistics. Now, do we roll hardcore, or do we roll softcore?
Well, that's kind of up to you.
Mm-hmm.
Let me see. Does it give you both suggestions, or does it just say one or the other?
I don't know.
I'm going to look. I'm going to say. To determine characteristics, roll 2d6, one after another, and assign the scores in any in order you wish to the six characteristics, starting with strength. Record them on the character sheet. And they are...
Do you have a loner pencil?
Yes, I have a loner pencil.
Do you have two
but it has
pencils?
No tip.
Well, that's
but
useful.
There is a there's a pen.
Okay, I'll do.
You want a piece of paper?
No, I have. I could acquire pen and paper if I needed to, but I was just going to.
I have another pen.
No, I'm fine. I'm
there's
good.
There's a pen.
Thank you.
I'm gonna.
You don't want a pencil?
Was it yours? Is it still sitting here?
I gotta use this pen.
Oh, then I'll use a pencil.
I use pen. I don't make mistakes. I don't make mistakes.
No.
It's called creativity.
Mm-hmm.
So it's strength, dex, endurance, intelligence, education, social standing. Strength, dex, and int, edu, sock.
All right. Now, it's kind of helpful to have in your head a little bit about what kind of person you want to be when you're putting your stats in.
Mm-hmm.
Like, even if you don't necessarily know a career path that you're going to go for,
right.
Be like, if you want to be a physically active person, you want to mm-hmm. be a fat guy, you know, you figure out.
I've already
but I can just assign them however I want, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. And I've named my character.
And
oh, shoot. I forgot on this dice. Which one is this? Oh, it's a six. Okay.
Sweet.
I'm rolling very average.
Oh.
Are you rolling fantastic?
Well, I started 9.
Booyah!
Oh, that's where it's at right there.
I'm really good at something.
And after I roll my array, I'll read them out to everybody. Hey, you know what?
Behind the computer, I can't see what I wrote for.
So, I ended up with my 6 stats being a 9, a 9, which are both pretty above mm-hmm. average and pretty good. Then a stumbling block of a 4.
Fantastic.
Then a 7, a 7, and an 8. So, fairly middle of the road.
Yeah. One dump stat.
Yeah. I just have to figure out what it's going to be.
Wow. All right. I got 11, 6, 7, 10, 3.
Fantastic.
11.
Wow.
Whoa. That's super high.
7, 8, 8, 6, 9, 12. Very average until the very end.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you don't have any failings.
No.
No. I mean, nothing horrible anyway.
No.
Yeah. Not like 3 and 4 over here. Yeah. Right. Like, I try and shoot someone. Bang, bang.
Or I try to think of something smart.
I will puzzle my way out of this problem.
So I am going to make a character who is good at shooting people.
Okay.
And I'm going to put my 12 in dexterity.
I'm going to make a smart guy. Put my 2 9s in int and education.
What'd I do? Oh, no.
Maybe I'll be like the smart guy that's asthmatic and have a 4 endurance.
I'm going to make my int 6. Is that still a DM 0?
No, I don't believe so. I believe the 6 is a negative 1.
No, it's 0.
Oh, it is?
6 through 8 is 0.
Well, if we have a shooty and a smarty, then maybe
well, this is a this is a character if there's anyone that happens to be...
Yeah, but she's just saying in general.
Yeah. You can make... You don't have to... I can make something else.
No, that's right. Fine. Then I'll be, like, socially.
Nice. That's a good balance.
Mm-hmm. So I'm going to write down my DMs real quick. Oh, plus... 12 is only a plus 2. I feel robbed.
Isn't this super entertaining, guys? Aren't you entertained?
It's going to get better.
Once we actually start playing, it will be fine. A lot of DM zeros.
You know what? I'm going to be the antisocial guy.
That's your dump stat?
Yeah. Social 4.
So you were born in, like, the belt.
Yeah.
There you go.
Sa-sa.
When's the next book?
Not long.
Is it coming out soon?
I think.
That would be nice.
I would like that.
So the next thing on this magic spreadsheet, go.
So up to 8 is 0.
Yes. 6 through 8 is 0.
And then 9 is a plus 1.
I didn't give you this sheet?
I'm sure it's there, but it was right there.
Okay, that's fine.
And wait, what's a 4? It's only a negative 1. That's not so bad.
Negative 1 is practically 0.
I got it.
They only go to plus or minus 3.
Right.
And you can't get a 3 without some sort of intervention with the system. So what does it say? We know we don't character. It says, now, background skills on page 8. Choose EDU DM plus 3 background skills. So take the die modifier, which is that little tiny... Did you get your DMs?
No.
No. You got your numbers? Don't write them down on your character sheet. You want a piece of paper?
No, I'll write it on the edge.
I got an extra character sheet, so...
Okay. Or I can write it on the back of something.
If you need to. It's fine.
Because on the first or second page of mm-hmm. that packet I gave you mm-hmm. is the DMs
mm-hmm.
for your rolled stats.
Okay.
So, like, since you're multiple 11s...
I see.
You're going to get plus 1s.
Oh, I see.
That feels like robbery. The 11 at plus 1
right?
feels like you're getting robbed. But it makes that 12 really exceptional.
Yeah, but it's only a plus 2.
You didn't come to welcome me.
I'll come out and say hello right now. I'll be back in just a second.
Sure. Okay.
I'm just knocking forever.
At the door? I don't want you to have your phone.
What kind of chocolate is that?
Mine.
I know what kind.
Milk.
Oh. Oh,
what? Milk chocolate.
Oh, yummy. That's my favorite, except for caramel chocolate. I love caramel chocolate. Xander, who's there?
Okay.
All right.
So, background
skill. The
chat room
says they're entertained, by the way, so good for them.
Yay!
All right, let's see.
So my education is plus 1, so I get 4 background skills from page 8.
Maybe my dub stamp will be education. They're just super charming.
I never went
never
to school.
Had a lick of school. I like that. That's
you
kind
just
of an interesting concept.
Down home country,
yeah.
Super friendly. That works. All right. So, from background skills, I get to choose 4. I think I'm going to go with... I should just make my guy completely random. Like, I'll pick art and electronics and streetwise and drive. Like, no, I'll take vac suit at 0. So, for those of you watching at some point, whether live now or later, I'm attempting to try and migrate to a paperless RPG lifestyle because I found that if I have papers, I lose them. So, if I have it all contained in a device, I don't lose it as often. So, I'm working on it. It's kind of a little rough still.
Mm-hmm. Everyone who rolled an 11 or higher gets a shot of Jameson's. And everyone who rolled a 12 or higher gets a shard of Ardbeg.
Well, I get nothing. I get nothing. Being average
crap.
Sucks.
Oh, wait. No, you can have some of this. Well, I can't reach the Ardbeg.
Well, I didn't roll anything good.
Well, you don't want
any? Yeah, all right, what the heck.
It's bourbon.
Well, I rolled Jameson.
The rules have been laid out, Stu.
I'm not making you have Jameson. Jameson's okay.
Yeah, it's free.
It gets the job done.
For free, it's great.
And it's fine.
Those are really big shots.
Oh, it's from the South. We won't be supporting the crown. Did I ever tell you that story?
I don't think so, no.
About, I went to a long time ago. Went to a bar called O'Connell's in Long Beach.
Mm-hmm.
A guy that, I don't know if he was the owner, but he was a bartender there. And his name was Murph.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he had an accent. Irish, obviously.
Yeah.
And I walked in. I thought, well, I'm in an Irish bar. I only knew of one Irish whiskey at the time, which was Bushmills.
Mm-hmm.
So I told him, I got a shot of Bushmills. And he looks at me sideways and says, are you sure you wouldn't be having Jameson's? What? Are you sure you wouldn't be having Jameson's? okay. What's the difference? Well, Bushmills is made in the north.
Yes.
Jameson's made in the south.
One is Protestant.
Like, okay, well, I'll have a shot of Jameson's then. I liked you as soon as you walked in. We wouldn't want to be supporting the crown.
So, that's awesome.
Yeah. And to this day, I have no idea if he was actually Irish or if he just put on the accent because he worked at a place called O'Connell's.
That would be awesome.
Which, I mean,
either
did you guys pick your... skills already? Your background skills?
I have picked my background skills.
I haven't. I, so you I get got distracted.
EDU DM plus 3?
Yes.
So my, so I get 3.
I got 4. I went with Vac Suit 0.
That's a handy skill.
Yeah. Language 0. Electronics 0.
Now, language, do you have to specify a language?
I'm sure I will, but we'll get there.
Right, okay.
I don't want to pick one.
And what was your third?
Electronics 0.
Mm-hmm.
And then admin 0.
Oh, you have you got a roll to 10?
What?
You have a plus one DM?
I'm sorry.
Yeah, I got a 9.
How do we figure out how many skills we have?
Your education die DM. Modifier.
Did you use that as your dump
stat? Yeah, I totally did.
Plus 3.
All right. So
what did you roll? 3?
2. No, I have... I rolled a 3, so I had a negative 1. So if I get 3, then I get 2.
You get 2
from
background
that list right there, yeah.
2 background skills.
And do you see the list of background skills? They're in that.
They're on the page down the corner. And then my character is smart. So I'm going to go to college. That's the next thing.
My int is 6. Is there like a community college? I could go to that.
No.
There isn't?
There's military academy or university. No. That's it.
I don't think I'm good enough to go to military academy or university. So maybe. I can try. I can always try.
Well, the thing is, okay, so this is kind of a new thing. They're calling it pre-career education. And you can choose to do it at several points.
Oh.
So if you try now and fail, then you go on to careers.
Right.
But if you wait and try later, it's easier because you're a little more experienced. You know how to concentrate and not be like going out drinking every night.
Right.
That kind of thing.
It's like when I went to college and then I went and worked for McDonnell Douglas and then I went back to college to get a degree, like because I was working nights at McDonnell Douglas.
Sure.
I'm like, oh, I'll go and get a degree. And I'm like, these kids can't shut up.
Yeah.
And I
need to focus here.
I was only like 26 or 27.
Yeah.
I was not a lot older than these kids.
Mm-hmm. There's the huge difference just looking at college freshmen and college seniors.
Oh, yeah. Yeah,
like,
there
in
is.
In just that 4-year gap, it's right. Like, oh,
yeah.
My God.
Oh, yeah. The liver damage alone is astonishing.
Well, yeah, yeah. But at the same time, it kills off all the hyper brain cells. So they just start to mellow out.
They're man. Always the first to go.
Yes. Yeah. What is admin?
Legitimately like bureaucratic.
Excellent.
Like how you deal with.
Yeah, that's a little too close to real life.
Let me read it. Let me read it because it is my opinion that the admin skill always gets kind of a short shrift. Because it might actually be more interesting than any of us think it is.
I know advocate
is
law.
It's really not.
This skill covers bureaucracies and administration of all sorts, including the navigation of bureaucratic obstacles or disasters. It also covers tracking, inventories, ship manifests, and other records. Avoiding close examination of papers. Average. DC 8.
Sure.
Admin check. Dealing with police harassment, difficult, 10 plus. Okay, so it's not as interesting.
Not
as
interesting
thought.
As it goes.
No, but it's
a useful skill.
Yeah.
Yes.
Useful.
It so, has application. It's not just navigating red tape. It's
right.
Oh, you don't want to show somebody your real passport.
Right. So I'm going to say John Casey Biggins. Wants to become a ship captain.
Okay.
A vast.
No, like in the Navy. Like in the Space Navy.
Yeah. So here's, I'm about to make my first roll.
No, hold on. Did you figure out where you're from? Do you have to figure out where you're from?
No. I'm from Earth.
From Earth.
Because there's universities there.
Okay. Are you going to try to get into university?
That's what I'm trying.
All right.
Here it comes. So I have to make an education roll of 7 or higher. In my case, that means I have to roll a 6 or higher on my dice because I have plus 1 to my education.
Right.
So here we go. I got an 8.
Bam!
I have entered university.
You a college boy? Woo. You look like a college boy.
That's right. Let me put on my sweater.
So my character was a farm boy from Nebraska who wants to become a starship captain.
Good for you. Good for you. Pick another state there in the middle. That's a good because you want to leave.
Right.
You want to get on a starship and go.
So for my background skills, I'm taking animals.
Very good.
Okay.
Used to herd Nebraskan mammals.
Cattle?
Sure. Okay. They might have those there.
Prairie dogs?
Yes.
Yes. You were prairie dogs. You were a fancy prairie dog breeder. You started a whole trend.
What is it, the disease that they carry in their feces? Is it anthrax? No.
Hantavirus.
Is it Hanta?
That's mice. Mice?
No,
the Hantavirus.
Prairie dogs, I thought. No, it's like something that was weaponized.
Like ricin?
No, ricin's a chemical
castor
from
bean.
Castor beans.
Yeah.
We all know this because we both looked this stuff up because we GM games.
Right, right. That's the thing. Like, if you play RPGs,
watch
don't
list.
Do bad things because as find soon you. As a cop has to investigate your search history, you're fucked.
That's right. What diseases are in... prairie dog feces.
Ah, the entertainment value of Googling things.
That are weaponized.
I really wish that there's some guy at the NSA that actually is actively watching my Google searches. Because he's going to be so confused.
So we're up to 15 people watching our character creation now.
Really?
All live. Yeah.
No kidding. No? That's amazing.
And that's just on Twitch. But I don't think the YouTube thing worked. It froze up and it's weird. So we'll figure that out.
Oh, really? That's a shame.
We have to troubleshoot it again. Sorry, people who are watching on YouTube. We'll figure it out.
Monkeypox?
Okay.
I don't know. I thought it was anthrax. I thought you could get anthrax from...
Perhaps. I don't know. I've been tested for anthrax. It's horrid.
You worked in water. They stick something way up your
nose. Oh, my
sinuses.
God. Yeah. I felt like I was being mummified. Because it's a Q-tip that's longer than this pencil.
Oh, my God.
And they go, and you feel it in the top of your head. It's like, and they jiggle it all around and then pull it back out and stuff it in the thing. Guy in one of those yellow hazmat suits.
Holy metric.
Not awesome. Just FYI.
So you were working there during 9/11?
Yeah.
Oh, no shit. Wow. That's the scariest place to be.
I was in my apartment, and I had just gotten up.
Wow.
And I hadn't started work yet. I was supposed to start work the next week.
Oh, really?
And it was kind of awesome, because all the news broadcasts there...
Fuck it, I'm out.
No. The news broadcasts there were much more horrifying than the truth. Because people were reporting, like, car bombs going off all over the
city.
Oh,
yeah, I remember.
And all kinds of ridiculousness. And we were all like, oh, my God!
Right. And then it's like Armageddon.
Yeah, well, and then immediately...
Which, for many people, it was.
The military's out on the streets.
Right.
So there's Humvees parked at every major intersection.
Mm-hmm.
And they had F-15s from Andrews flying cap over the city.
Wow.
And that's kind of horrifying, because all of a sudden, they're only like 100 feet above my apartment building.
Right.
And they're like, especially after on television, everybody says, all flights have been grounded domestically. And then you hear, you're like, oh my God, why? Oh, okay, it's just good guys. So, since I got into university, I get to choose a 0-level skill and a level 1 skill from a list. Exciting times, a list. I'm going to take astrogation at 1.
I'm going to take athletics as my second background skill. Did you get your background skills yet, Kimmy?
I did, I got them.
What'd you take?
Athletics and survival.
Yeah.
So let's see. If I'm going to be a starship captain, mm-hmm. I have to have a pre-career education. And I need to try to join...
The military academy?
The military academy.
Mm-hmm. That's a good choice.
That's a good choice.
So I want to join Navy, which is Int 9+. My intelligence is 6. So I need to roll 9+. I rolled an 11.
You wrecked
it. I went to... So, no, I don't know what to do now. So this is Naval Academy. Term 1. Gain all service skills of the military career of the academy is tied to at level 0, as with basic training. So I need to find the Navy page. Need help?
No. I'm going to wait and let you do it for a minute, and then it'll be my turn. We're going to kind of rotate.
That's fine.
I think I rolled high enough on social that I get to be, like, a noble.
Navy. What's your social?
11.
11, yeah.
Well, I think so, yeah. That's on one of those early pages in the packet.
Page 9, in fact.
Those are, since we're not playing Imperium, it's not going to be probably those titles, unless that's you want them to be.
No, I don't really care.
But.
I totally am super excited about being, like, the, like, loser daughter of some rich baron or something. I'm just, like, finding myself in, like, the version of Traveller Burning Man.
Gain all service skills of the military career the academy is tied to. So, all service skills, these. Okay. So I have animals already at 0. Athletics at 0. Pilot. Back suit. Athletics again. Now, do I take it at 1 now? If I get it at 0 again?
I believe so. Unless it specifically says only at 0.
Oh, it says at 0. So I don't get it again.
Yeah.
Gunner. Mechanic. Gun combat.
Are we on the Wi-Fi? We should not be on the Wi-Fi if we have the option.
I'm not sending or receiving any data.
Or is the feed hurt?
No, they're saying it's buffering, but they're not sure if it's on their end or our end. So I'm.
Is it more than one of them saying that?
Yeah.
Then it's probably our end.
Maybe. Oh no, not everyone says they're having a problem. We'll see.
Okay, so I've done my first. And then, how many terms? Is it just one term?
Well, it should have a what happens next.
I'm just going under Military Academy. I'll look at the chart. Where's the chart? There's the chart. Pre-career, choose university or military academy. Gain skills, roll for event, roll for graduation. So I have to roll for an event first, and that's 2d6. 7. Life event. Roll on the life event table. See page 44. Life event. There's only 12 life events. There's only 12 things that can happen to you in your life. And I rolled a 10. Good fortune!
Good fortune!
Something good happens to you. You come into money unexpectedly, have a lifelong dream come true, get a book published, or have some other stroke of good fortune, gain plus 2 DM to 1 benefit roll. So, in term 1, life event, good fortune, plus 2 to 1 benefit. So, I'll make a note of that. And then I roll for graduation. Now I need to have an 8 or higher, and my DM is 0. So I need an 8 or higher. Do I graduate or do I not graduate? If end is 8+, which it is, DM plus 1. If social standing is 8 plus, wait, plus 1 DM, if end is 8 or higher, it is, social is only 7, so plus 1. So I need a 7 or higher. And I did not graduate. I was a dropout. Did not graduate. Okay, it's your turn.
All right. So social standing, nobility. If a group includes a traveler with a high social standing, we recommend one of the following courses. Sons, daughters, and more distant relatives to a named noble may carry a great deal of social weight without actually having a title themselves. Though they may well inherit later. So that's kind of the one I liked.
Okay, all right.
There's a table that says 11 knight, but I don't really care. So I like that
idea. It could easily be like the CEO of a large-ish corporation.
Right. So I really like the idea of like my dad being like this like really rich, great person, and I am totally like the dropout loser daughter.
The rebellious.
Like, yeah, the rebellious. Like, I dropped out to have a band. I never, like, finished school. I'm probably a drummer.
That would explain not finishing school.
Right? So this is, like, my my course of action.
Got it.
Awesome.
So go ahead. And are you going to go to college?
I guess I should go. I probably would have gone.
Okay. Regular college or military academy?
Not military academy.
Okay. So you're going to roll EDU 7 plus.
Can I go to, like, an arts college?
Sure.
Well, you could pick art as one of your possible choices.
Oh, yeah. You get.
Yeah, okay. So I'm sorry.
But it's still an education roll of 7 or more.
Okay.
2d6? Your social is really high, right?
2d6.
Mm-hmm. Yes, my social is super
high. So you get plus 1 to your die modifier.
Oh. Daddy's helping out.
Yeah, he totally is.
So you're going to roll... What's your education?
3.
Minus 1?
So minus 1, yes.
So you're just a flat roll.
Okay.
You got to roll 7 or higher.
All right.
To get into university.
Yes. Oh, yeah. I got 9. So I got into university.
Some then I roll to work.
So my dad bought a building.
Once you're in, you choose skills at level 0 and... You choose a level 0 and a level 1 skill from the following list.
Okay.
You have that sheet.
I know. Which one? Where is
that's it right there.
Page 14.
It'll be at the second column, about halfway down.
But okay. You may want to let her see the whole skills list in here for all the subheadings under the different...
Oh, for the different...
Like art, any.
Right.
Art.
They'll have a whole bunch. Or whatever you choose to go with.
Yeah.
Art.
You could get, like, a 0 skill in advocate because you've been arrested so many times.
I could do that. I like that.
Well, I mean, I'm not trying
to
force you.
No, that's a really good idea, actually.
like you're like, you know how the bail system works.
Works.
the art skill specialties are performer,
holography.
I would say holography. Instrument, visual media, or write.
Writing.
It says write.
I'll do a performer.
I have a degree in right.
I'm right! My art is being correct!
So I'll do one in perform. And then
one
in
perform.
Yeah, and then
so
I
have
like
a 0 and a 1.
Yeah, so one. So I'll do 0 in advocate. I like that.
Okay.
So then we both have to roll
your
on
roommate
the event
was pre-law.
Table.
Yeah.
That's on page 15.
Well, and I like that, like, I got arrested a couple times. I had stuff I shouldn't
campus
have.
Campus security knows you by name.
Right. Yeah.
So on page 15, you have to roll a life event.
Okay.
So you roll 2d6, and then it tells you what happened to you during college.
5.
Taking advantage of youth.
Yeah!
You party as much as you study. Gain carouse 1.
Nice. All right.
Fate has smiled upon you.
I know, right? That's
here we go. Perfect. Let's see what happens to me.
Oh, this is your life
this
event?
This is my life event. 8. I join a political movement. Roll social, 8+. If successful, I become a leading figure. Gain an ally within the movement, but gain one enemy in wider society.
Awesome! I need to make notes.
Well, let's see if I make an 8+ social roll, because I'm -1. Oh, I totally did!
That, right? What, do you have a character name yet? No, I'll just put
no,
Dave.
I don't, yeah.
Dave.
And that's the worst for me.
So you have an ally...
I have one ally within some political movement. but I have an enemy in wider society.
Dun, dun, dun.
Political movement. Plus one ally.
I joined the, like, equal rights for spacers.
Yep. Right.
I did not carouse in college, actually, chat room. But thanks.
I did.
So did I.
Super boring. Nope, I worked all day, studied all night, and played MMOs all the time.
They didn't have MMOs when I was in college.
They did when I was in college. And I played them a little. And then I played EverQuest a lot when it came out.
Yeah.
I played a lot of GURPS in college, and I also drank a lot.
We totally didn't know that about you.
Yeah.
I didn't RPG in college, except for at the end.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it just wasn't convenient. I couldn't find a store nearby in D.C.
Oh, that sucks.
Wasn't a thing.
I was too busy playing with people I didn't know on the internet.
Okay, so now that I'm out, does that mean I have to go find a career?
Well, did you graduate?
No.
You haven't graduated yet, then. You got to make a role for that.
Oh, I got to stay in college until I graduate?
I guess.
So I'm going to be in 8 years?
Well, let's see.
What's the flow chart say? Did you graduate? Go to jail.
Gain and gain skills, roll an event, roll for graduation. If you graduate, gain graduation benefits, start a new career. If you didn't, you just start a new career, but you don't get graduation benefits.
Okay, I don't get graduation bennies, but I start a new career.
So you didn't make your graduation roll?
I did not make my graduation.
Oh, okay. I have to see what mine is, so hang on.
Oh, yeah, you got to see if you graduated.
Yeah, yeah. My graduation roll is a 7 plus int roll. If I get 11 plus, I graduate with honors. With a U in it.
Did you graduate?
I didn't roll that word.
Yeah, okay.
If I don't and you do, I'm going to be pissed.
I mean, an arts degree. All I have to do is, like, have a pulse and turn in a final project.
That happens. Jack would like to apologize to any art people with art degrees out there.
That are probably the people watching.
Who... I'm sure you all have pulses.
Right, that's how they...
I'm 100% sure that statement is accurate. All right, so here we go.
They could have pacemakers.
Int roll of 7 plus. They're just cyborgs, but they still have a pulse.
Yay, go educators. Okay.
Here we go.
Oh! Look at that.
That's butt. I got too involved with politics.
You got too, yeah?
Yeah.
You didn't have your mind on your studies. Chasing those wild dreams and those hippie girls.
Yep.
Space hippies.
Heading out to Eden.
In space, no one can hear your drum circle.
Oh. All right.
Oh, my God. Here, I have to roll to see if I graduate.
Graduation.
Oh, dang, man.
What?
Graduation's awesome.
Oh, yeah. It gives you lots of stuff.
Oh.
At least so I hear.
You wrecked it?
2 ones.
Nothing.
Yeah! You critically didn't graduate.
I critically failed graduation.
So if you roll a 2 on something, do you have to roll a mishap? How do you have mishaps?
No. There's no mishaps in this yet.
It's so perfect. I can't believe my rolls.
No, college has no mishaps.
Oh.
Because this doesn't count against you.
Mishap. Binge drinking.
Oh, man. Oh, my God.
So you didn't graduate either.
No, that's so perfect.
I'm telling everybody
the dice
I did.
Are like, yeah.
Because we're in space and
no one can call.
No one
knows.
What was your life event?
She
partied.
Oh, yeah, the party, the carousing.
All right. So now you can pick a career and try to get into it.
Okay.
Start new term. Choose career. Roll for qualification. If this is a new career, I'm gonna try going to the Navy because I can still become a starship captain.
You can. It's possible.
I'll let you guys go first.
So we just roll and see where it takes us. Or do we have to pick something?
You pick.
All right.
Is there a draft table? Do they still have a draft table?
Yeah. Probably, yes.
If you fail on all of your stuff,
then you have to roll on the draft table.
Then you have to...
Heading out to Eden.
Because you choose your career, you roll qualification. If you didn't make it, you roll for the draft, or you choose the drifter.
Right. Or you go out with a giant pipe cutter and cut down a bunch of parking meters and choose prison. Cool Hand Luke? No?
You could do that. I don't know how, if you can choose prison, is that...
It seems to me if you go out with a giant pipe cutter...
You are making
a
choice
of parking meters. You are choosing prison. I would say Cool Hand Luke chose prison.
You're right. You're right. Okay. You didn't give us the careers, did you?
I didn't.
You you gave us the list.
You have the list of
this
careers.
This is the super important page.
Okay.
For
it's
choosing
in the back.
Careers.
Okay. Ah,
yeah,
I
page
see.
19. So you look at the career heading first.
Mm-hmm.
And then the subheadings are the things that you could kind of aim at in that career.
Okay.
But you want to look at the like the career heading and then the qualification in the third column.
Okay.
Because like if it's something that's really, really hard for you to qualify for, mm-hmm. you might not want to try because that makes it riskier to try and get in.
Okay. It's right, there's chocolate.
Int plus six. Damn it. Why is everything based on intelligence? Kirk was not smart.
You could be a merchant marine. That's only int plus four. Or a dex plus six pirate.
Pirate?
Yeah, that's under the rogue career. It's based on dex.
No, oh, my dex of 12 would help with that.
Significantly, yeah. Light fingers. Light fingers Biggins. let's see.
How many people are you thinking to have in this game?
I don't know, four, five. Yeah. I mean, we can have a pool of people and see who's available mm-hmm. and play with whoever's here. They're all would be part of the same crew.
Mm-hmm.
That's a great idea.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to try for Navy.
Do it.
I'm going to do that.
Worst case scenario, you go to the draft. You might end up in the Navy anyway.
Right. Mm-hmm. So I need DM minus one for every previous career. There are none. DM minus two if you're age 34. Now, what does our age start out when we're out of college?
You'd have to look. Does it take a four-year chunk?
I took five.
No, not in real life, man. I'm talking about in the game. Does it count university like starting at age...
18, I would imagine. 18 to 22.
Mm-hmm.
That's what real life is. But...
RPGs are life, man.
Before a traveler embarks on a life career, there's educational options worth considering. This usually takes place in the traveler's first term in place of a career.
Okay, so he's 18, 22. So I'm under 34.
Yes.
I'm going to try to join the Navy and sail the seven seas.
Or the eighth sea, as they say.
I rolled an ocho.
You made it.
I made it. Term two, Navy. Now do I get the service skills again?
It's your first time in the career, so you get basic training, right?
Look at the flowchart.
Go back to the flowchart.
choose a career. If this is your first term for the career, go through basic training. Otherwise, choose the skill table and roll. Did it tell me what basic training is?
I believe basic training is all of the...
Service skills?
You get all the service skills.
Excellent. Now, do I up them still? I'll look.
Yeah.
Because I was in the military academy.
Oh, you're one of those guys.
Ooh.
You're the only one that graduated. You didn't graduate.
I didn't graduate.
None of us made it. We all wasted 4 years of our lives.
I got a lot of skills. I learned a lot in college.
You did. You actually got a lot more skills than we did.
Yeah.
Well, military academy gave me like six.
Yeah, I know. I know. Because you're drilled into knowing things.
I wasn't...
What shall I do?
I wasn't distracted by your hippie politics and drinking. let's see.
I'll be the dude in space. No, man.
I'm the dude, man.
That nebula really brought things together, man.
It really tied that room together. I'm going to get rugs in here. That'll help with sound.
Mm-hmm.
That'll help with sound bounce. And I found a... I don't remember where it was. I can get two, like, 12-foot rugs. Because a 12x9 is mostly going to be covered by this table.
Mm-hmm.
But if I get two of them and butt them up against each other,
mm-hmm.
I think it will really tie the room together.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
Because I want a rug that ties the room together.
Yes.
You might want to check IKEA. They have usually pretty good prices on some rugs.
Oh, do they? Okay.
IKEA's really good.
I looked at on Amazon. They were as low as somewhere between 100 and 200. For also, a 9x12 is...
Yeah, Costco also.
Oh, I hadn't thought of Costco. I'll go by Costco. So where's my...
The chat room says, yeah, when people spill beer and wine and liquor all over it, the aroma will really tie the room together.
It really will. You pee on my carpet.
Most spills happen on top of the table.
Yeah, on the character sheets.
On the game.
On books, actually.
I'm the only one that has wrecked a book.
No.
Somebody else did?
Stork did my vampire book. Oh, nice. I'll bring it down in a minute so you can see it. Oh, yeah, it's quite nice. It was open, and it got most of a glass of wine.
Awesome.
Yeah.
That's what I did to Bruce's Edge of the Empire book.
let's see. The first term, basic training. Basic training. Where's the thing for basic training? There should be like a page that tells me about basic training. It's got to be here.
Chat
basic
says,
training. Here it is. They're saying, it's on page 16. Jesus Christ.
They're saying Amazon has deep shag purple rugs on sale right now.
On sale, really?
Swanky.
Do you want shag?
No.
No, you have dog.
That's disgusting. That will be so gross so fast.
You probably have a very long haired
dog. Stop thinking about it.
I have an enormously long haired dog.
And then when Fenris comes...
He'll adhere to it like Velcro. And he won't be able to go home.
Well, at least
we'll just have him under the table.
Samantha won't need to comb him on one side.
Well, yeah, but I'm saying like
he'll leave it all there.
He'll have to live under the table like the Munster's dog in the stairs. He'll just have to throw like a side of beef under the table.
Plus, all our allergies go crazy.
Oh, that's true. Yeah. For first career only, you get all the skills listed under service skills at zero as your basic training. For any subsequent careers, you may pick any one skill listed in the service table at level zero as your basic training. Citizens and drifters are the exception to this. They both use their appropriate assignment skill for their basic training. All right. So I get all of these skills at... I think I already have all of these. I already have them all.
Oh, because you went into the same career you trained at.
But I was the military academy.
Right.
So I don't get any skills.
And then you went to boot camp, and they taught you the stuff that you already knew, so you're really good at it already.
Which is why I did so well.
And that's how you might end up being an LT.
Yeah.
Captain.
You have to start somewhere, whatever the promotion list is.
I don't know. I'll get to that.
It'd be like an ensign. Ensign Biggins.
Ensign Biggins. okay. So I did that. Skills. Roll survival. There's a survival. Survival. Survival.
It's up at the top. Career progress.
Ah, okay. Survival. Oh, I have to pick. Do I have to? I mean,
you
I get
to pick
a skill and a thing.
Category.
Do I mean I get a? Do I get a skill and a thing?
Yeah. Okay. So you start your new term. You qualified.
I did.
If it's the first term, go through basic training. You did that.
Well, hold on a second. Let me make sure I read all of basic training. For any subsequent careers, you may pick any one skill listed in service skills. No. Okay, that's it. So survival, I just roll. Did I just pick one? Line crew, engineer, gunner, or flight. I want flight, right? Because the captain's going to be under flight eventually, right?
Probably.
I would imagine.
Kind of depends on what kind of captain. You could be Captain Montgomery Scott of the engineers.
No, I want flight. He'd be engineer, gunner.
I thought you got to roll for a skill.
It doesn't say you get to roll for a skill.
Oh. If it's your first time, you get basic training. Otherwise, choose a skill table and roll.
Okay. So I am going to get... I need dex plus 7, or dex 7 plus, and I have a DM of 2.
So you only have to hit a 5.
Snap! Barely made it.
Barely made it, but you did.
I survive. And now I roll advancement? No,
now
I roll
event.
I roll an event. I roll 2d6 for an event. 7. Life event. Where's the life events table?
Well, there's a whole table.
44? Is that what it was on?
I don't know.
It's 40 something. I think it was 44. Yep, 44 to 4. Life event 5. Improved relationship.
Oh, nice for you.
Life event. Improved relationship.
You know what? I think I'm going to go for, no taxation without representation style. I was in college. I joined that movement that's all about the rights of off-world colonies.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And how they shouldn't have to send back economic support to Earth. Earth is fine on its own.
Political agitator.
Right.
Right.
But I left college, mm-hmm. didn't graduate, and I went off to be a colonist.
Excellent.
Okay.
On a newly settled extra-stellar mm-hmm. world.
To join the people's struggle.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
A romantic relationship.
So that'll be the career I went.
Involving you deepens, possibly leading to marriage or some other emotional commitment. Gain an ally.
Hmm.
Write down the whole thing, because those are really useful for when it comes time for us to make our connections.
I'll just put the number down, because there's only 12 life events.
Okay, but I mean, just a quick note, like romantic relationship.
Yeah, 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 I am.
That can be greatly useful. You know what you're going to do, or do you want me to go?
I have one of two things. I just have to figure out how it works more.
Okay.
Why don't you go, and then I'll...
You probably want to look at the in-depth descriptions that Stu has in the book.
There's really like two things that would work for my character. They're in totally separate places, but...
Yeah, yeah, but I mean, you might want to look at the actual page because it kind of shows you what you might end up with if you end up in one.
So let me roll my advancement and I'll finish this term.
Okay.
So education 5.
So you rolled your event. Check.
Right.
Is commission possible and do you wish to try?
Absolutely.
So it should have something about commission.
No.
Somewhere
there it
page?
Is. Social 8. Uh-oh. Well, I just got to roll 8 or higher. I can do it. No, I did not get a commission. Not this time.
Okay. So then you roll for advancement.
I get advancement.
Okay.
So now I'm 1 or am I 2? I started at 0. Now I'm 1. I'm an able space hand.
Nothing escapes my hand of space justice.
Promotion to 1. Able space hand. I'm going to give you the space hand.
Okay. Would you like to see my space hand? Nothing escapes my space handy notice.
No, space handy is different.
I'm glad you caught that.
I'm going to make sure my kids are in bed. We're back.
All right. So, I will go ahead and roll to see if I can become a citizen colonist.
Woohoo!
So my qualification to be a citizen is education of 5+. So my +1 on education means I only have to roll a 4. Watch me fuck this up. I did it! No! I got a 4! That's exactly what I needed.
Nice.
Perfect. So I will become a citizen colonist.
Excellent.
So for basic training, some of you may notice that I've started writing on a piece of paper because the downfall to trying to do it all digitally is flipping between the book that you're reading and the paper you have to write on the same device.
That sounds like a pain.
Yeah, not awesome. Excuse me. Sweet. As a colonist, I'm taught to fight.
My dog is losing his mind.
It's getting dark out here.
Why are we still here?
Please, let's go home. Why? Sweet. So I got a whole mess of skills at 0 for basic training.
Nice.
I got drive 0, flyer 0, streetwise 0, melee 0, steward 0, and profession, and I chose civil engineering 0. So I got that. Now I have to roll for survival as a colonist.
Oh, where are you going to be a colonist?
Some.
Is it going to be in the solar system or on another planet?
No, I was thinking on another planet, if that's okay.
Oh, yeah. I will look up stars that are close to Sol right now.
Where did you get the traveler books?
The traveler. What?
That the book, book? Yeah.
Print on demand.
Print on demand at DriveThruRPG. Yeah. Although I saw one, I don't know if it's still there, but I saw one in stock at Game Empire.
All right. So let's see if I survive being a colonist for 4 years. I need an int roll of 7+. Lucky, 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 lucky. Yeah!
Did you get 12?
No, I got an 8.
Oh.
So I survived. Now I get to roll an event.
I didn't realize Alpha Centauri was a triple star system.
Obviously, I can't live there. That's the closest to Earth.
Yeah.
Would most likely be one of the earliest colonized ones.
Yes. But is there likely to be a habitable planet if it's a triple star system?
That's up to you. It may just increase the habitable zone. You know? Move that habitable band. No, it doesn't have to orbit. Like, it could literally orbit all three suns if they're centrally located. The suns could be gravitationally close to each other, orbiting each other.
Right.
And then there could be a planetary system around all three.
Yeah, that's possible. Would that be stable?
We don't know. You could ask Stephen Hawking that question. He'd know better if it was gravitationally possible.
There's like programs that model.
Sure,
that.
Sure.
You could set one up and see if it.
Well, it would be just a single orbital path. It wouldn't make loop-de-loops.
Might? You don't know. You don't know. If there's three stars, depending where the stars are.
And then it just dips in between the two because it's.
And then the other one picks it up and flings it back out? I don't know. I don't know.
I think much more likely is a single large elliptical.
I think it's much more likely that the planet would just die in fire.
Well, that's fine. So then I'm not living there. I didn't choose death by fire.
Proxima Centauri
That's 4.2 light years. There's Banad Star. Although the other two Centauri systems are 4.3 and 4.3. So they're 0.1 light years away.
That's a significant distance.
That's a huge distance.
Yes.
I mean, it's 7 minutes from here to Mars when they were receiving messages, or 14 minutes, something like that. I don't remember. Yeah.
I think it stretches between like something like that and like 38 at the upper end.
Okay.
Depending on where we are.
The chat room is informing us. Proxima Centauri, which is in the Alpha Centauri system, has been found to be a very Earth-like planet. It was announced about a month ago.
Okay.
And then Alpha and Beta Centauri orbit each other closely. Proxima orbits them both at a distance.
Okay. All right. So we'll say Proxima Centauri.
Okay.
Sure.
So the planet on Proxima Centauri.
I should write that down. You know what that makes me?
A centaur.
A centauri.
Yeah. You're the assassin of joy.
I'm gonna have to start styling my beard and grow my hair.
Assassin of joy.
It'll be so good. So good. It's a colony entirely of Babylon 5 nerds. You have to pass a test to join. So I'm going to roll an event now on my citizenry. Sweet! I am rewarded for my diligence or cunning. Gain 2 dice modifier to my next advancement check.
Oh, make a note. I'm not going to note that. I'm only noting people.
All right, so I had my event. The commission is not possible. So now I will roll to see if I advance. And advancement is an endurance roll. And my endurance modifier is 0, but I'm a +2 from my event. Owned. I go from a rank 0 colonist to a rank 1 colonist. And I get nothing.
Dirt farmer.
No new name. No nothing.
I imagine you're a dirt farmer. No, you were a dirt farmer, now you're a potato farmer.
They've given me seeds.
Tubers. You're a root farmer.
Rank 1.
Oh, someone should remind me to put my mic on when I sit back down.
Put your mic on when you sit back down.
All right.
Do that.
Luckily, you were just mostly coughing, so they just missed that.
And wheezing. Mm-hmm. Don't forget the wheezing.
Right. Wheezing.
I am going to continue Traveler Creation.
Did you do your
first
turn?
Not yet.
I just finished my first turn.
Excellent.
Yeah, so we're taking turns. All right, so... I decided what I want to be, what I want to do, so how do I do that?
Okay, so what's the big heading?
Noble.
Okay, so you have to roll to to enter the noble profession, which is a social roll of 10 plus.
Oh, shit.
But you get a DM.
You get your dice modifier on your social
stat. Plus one.
Okay.
Plus one.
Okay. So you need a 9. Easy peasy.
No problem.
Oh, wait. Automatic qualification if your social is 10 or higher.
Oh, so
I didn't even need to roll. Good thing.
Good thing, because I would have failed.
So then, you have now become a noble.
All right, I'm a noble.
Congratulations.
Go me.
You now get to get the service skills listed on that chart.
Okay.
All of them at 0.
Okay, cool.
If you already have one at 0, you still stay at 0.
Okay.
Like if you happen to have learned one of those skills previously, right. It doesn't add to it. It's just
right. Where are they listed?
Up one column and to the right one. There you go.
Ah, got them.
That whole list.
And it's 0.
Yep.
Interesting.
You need a lot of cash on the noble table nowadays.
Do you? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, on the mustering out benefits, it goes all the way up to 200,000 credits.
Holy metric.
In one roll.
Wow.
That's pretty good.
All right.
Okay, so you took those service skills.
Mm-hmm.
Then you have to roll for survival. So you have to choose what type. I'm assuming you went with dilettante.
Yeah.
Not administrator or diplomat.
No, that doesn't matter.
Because you'd be like, I am the diplomat of the drums. Yeah!
You don't know.
Renoir! So you have to survive, you have to make a social roll of 3+.
Okay, I can do that.
You sure?
I should. I hope so.
You can't miss it.
Do double ones count as an automatic failure?
I have no idea.
Roll. She and if you get double ones, we'll worry about looking it up. So don't do that.
Okay.
Yeah.
No, you're fine. You mean, cool.
Yeah.
You survived.
Yay!
So now you roll an event.
Okay.
Which is the
Am I
table.
Dilettante now?
Yeah, you are totally
I'm
a dilettante.
I'm a dilettante. Event.
Yeah, so you roll 2d6, and mm-hmm. then something's going to happen to you.
Eat. A conspiracy of nobles attempts to recruit you. If you refuse, gain the conspiracy as an enemy. If you accept, roll deception 8+ or persuade 8+. If you fail in the roll, the mishap table and conspiracy collapses. If you succeed, gain one level of deception, persuade, tactics, or carouse.
Oh.
Hmm.
So essentially you made friends with Ferris Bueller.
Yeah, I mean, that seems like something I'd probably accept.
So you're going to accept it? Does that give you an enemy? Is that what it says?
No.
If you deny
roll
them out front, you have to make a roll.
Oh, 8+, or persuade 8+.
So you don't have persuade or...
I have persuade at 0.
Okay, so roll it. What does it say what the DM is supposed to be?
Deception. 8+.
Oh, okay.
Well, so you use your persuade skill,
mm-hmm.
and then... Normally they pair with a...
Right, I don't know if it does for character.
If it doesn't say, it probably doesn't. So,
yeah.
So you'd
have to just
roll an 8 or higher.
Yeah.
But you're not at -2, so
yeah.
Congrats.
Because normally if you don't have a skill, you're at -2.
Oh, yeah, that's good. Okay.
So you have to roll an 8 or higher. Or you could just be like, no, I'm not going to join your whatever conspiracy. It could literally be like a bunch of your unemployed noble friends that are like...
So, we're going to steal a starship and go to...
We're totally going to steal my dad's yacht and go do something.
See, that seems like something I'd do. If it's them being like, we're going to... I don't know. Right, yeah, I'm going to go for it.
All right.
I'm totally going to steal the yacht. Yeah.
Or whatever you decide. It could, you know...
11.
You rocked it!
11? That's
9,
2.
9, 10, 11.
Oh,
6. Sorry. It's a 6. 7, 8. Sorry, it's an 8.
But
I still
made
got it.
You still made it.
Sorry. You looked at it for a second, too. You looked at it.
You just rolled a 9 on a d6. That's awesome.
That's impressive.
Holy shit. Sorry. You broke space-time.
I'm not used... It has been so long since I've played any games that roll d6s.
No, it's totally fine.
Okay.
I rolled an M.
Usually there's like a little line.
You need dice with dots.
Well, that's the problem. They're my Orcon dice, so it has an Orcon logo instead
for one of the six.
Instead of the 6.
Oh, okay.
Okay. So then you get to pick a skill, I think, right?
So yeah. Succeeded. So I got 8. If you succeed, gain one level of I gave one level of deception, persuade, tactics, or carouse. So that makes me 0, right?
If you don't have the skill at all, it takes you to 0. If you already have a 0, in this case, you're gaining a level,
mm-hmm,
so you
would
go up to a 1.
So you.
What is carouse exactly? I
guess. Literally,
partying?
Your ability to party and drink, and well, like Marion versus Indy in Raiders of the Lost Ark is a carouse roll.
Yeah. Okay.
Sort of like the drinking game to see who falls under the table first, mm-hmm. or getting information out of a bunch of people at a bar without sounding like. Hey, you guys with information, I would like to know things, please.
Yeah.
Right, like knowing how to schmooze.
Okay. I feel like I need deception. That seems like a good thing to take. Cool, all right. I did a thing.
Awesome. So you did your event, and you didn't end up with a mishap or anything. Mm-hmm. So there's no commission for being a dilettante. Mm-hmm. So you now roll for advancement.
Okay.
So advancement roll is an int roll of 8+.
Ooh.
So you use
okay, int's not bad.
You just have to roll 8 or higher, and then you go up on the dilettante chart.
6, 7, 8 with my +1.
So you go from the rank 0 dilettante, the wastrel, to now a unnamed dilettante.
Excellent.
It doesn't have a name.
It's probably like advanced wastrel.
Yeah.
Wastrel first class.
There we go. Okay.
Yes. The best part is if you advance again, you become an ingrate.
That's the best.
And advance 2 more times, you become black sheep.
Oh, no kidding. So you actually get worse.
Yeah, and then 2 more times, you become the scoundrel.
Scoundrel.
Wow, that's awesome.
Yeah.
Cool. All right, so we're back to you, Stu.
Oh, it's back to me. Okay. I need to borrow the book again. So I'm back to the navvy. Term 3, term 2 in the navvy.
Oh, and you did give yourself the skill mechanic 1 for being an able space hand?
No. Oh, I forgot. Oh, no, I didn't. I gave myself mechanic 1.
Certain, when you advance certain ranks, it'll give you some kind of a skill bonus.
Got it. Mechanic 1. All right. Do I need to qualify again?
No, you're in.
I'm in.
So you don't have to qualify. You just now choose a skill.
And is that from service? Or
no, you can pick any of those columns that you qualify for.
I roll, right?
And you roll a d6, and you get one of those things.
So advanced education, minimum education of 8. I have that. I could do that.
Mm-hmm.
Officer, commissioned only, can't do that. Line crew, or I could do flight.
Right, you can't do the other two if you didn't pick those.
I will try flight.
Okay.
1, pilot.
Very nice.
Now I already have it. Now it is 1.
Yes.
Okay. All right.
Unless you're choosing to pilot something. Like, I think pilot has different categories.
It just says pilot. Down here is pilot small craft. But I picked this pilot.
Right, but I'm saying you could apply those to, like, if you already had pilot 0.
Right.
You could apply that pilot to something else.
Right. Like, I'll wait and figure it out.
Yeah, you can figure that out later. It's fine.
Okay.
So you got a skill. Now you have to roll survival.
Survival is for flight dex +7, so I'm at +2. Five,
yes,
6, 7. I made it, exactly.
Just made it.
Woo!
Now you roll in the event table again.
7.
Another life event.
44.
You're a life eventer. Those life events are how you get some wacky stuff, though, so.
Yes.
You could be the psionic pilot ship captain.
Oh.
Kimmy is also on the way to ending up being the,
gain a contact.
Alcoholic
esteemed
friend.
Senator from Massachusetts.
+1 contact. All right.
So what was your life event, just so we can hear?
New contact. You gain a new contact.
Oh. So somewhere in the course of your Navy career,
I met someone who...
Somebody that can help you.
Might help me.
Cool. So then you...
Oh, commission?
You can try to get commission.
I'm going to try to get commission. I need an 8.
Oh, yeah. So close, but not.
Not really.
So now you can roll for advancement.
Advancement, and I need a 5, and this is education, which is +1.
So you are now a petty officer 3rd class. You gain vac suit 1.
Yoo-hoo!
Nice.
Okay. And this is rank 2 now, right?
You are now rank 2, yeah.
All right. That's it, right?
Yep, that's a 4-year term.
All right, thank you.
All right. So then I'll go ahead while you get yourself set up. So I am going to roll on the personal development table. No, the colonist table.
Excellent.
1d6. Here we go. Damn it.
What'd you get?
I got a 6.
What's that give you?
Recon. But if I'd gone with personal development, like I said, I'd got jack of all trades.
Oh! Why would you roll on any other table?
Because it was on the other table, too! If I'd rolled a 3, my chances of rolling mid-grade much higher. On a D6, I'm more likely to roll a 3 than a 6.
That is not true.
In my personal experience, due to my luck factor.
That is not true.
It is true.
It is not true.
Would you say it's not true for Stork?
It is not true for Stork. Now, if you were to say I'm more likely to roll a 3 or a 4 than a 6, I would agree with you. I would almost say it was twice as likely.
You're right. So I got Recon 1.
Handy skill, Recon. A million uses. Just the right length.
There's some stuff over there. There's some stuff over there, too.
I think in the old Traveller, in the Mercenary book, there was a forward observer skill.
Oh, okay.
A little bit to the left. A little more.
2 degrees up, bubble.
A little more. back a little.
Too much! All right, so I got that. Now I got to roll my survival, which is an int roll of 7 plus. I got a 6 and I have a plus 1, so that's a 7. Then I roll for an event. Got a 10. I gain experience in a technical field as a computer operator or surveyor. Increase electronics or engineer by 1 level. I'll do electronics. Okay. Then after my event, I'm going to try and roll for advancement, which is an endurance roll of 5 or higher, because I just have to survive, basically, live there, which I made. And now I become a settler.
Well done.
Congratulations.
Mm-hmm. And I gain survival 1. Cool.
Come here.
All right.
Nothing horrible's happened yet, everybody.
No.
Except for the world dropouts.
You said that. And
well, that's the you were.
Why did you say
there is a mishap table, I'm assuming, for.
They're totally. If you don't make the survival roll.
Right. Are we going to do the thing where everyone rolls a mishap at the end?
That's up to you.
That's totally your thing.
I think so. I'm sure
that. Totally. So what do I do now?
So are you going to stay in as a dilettante?
I feel like this is my life.
That's your calling. Yeah.
My calling in life is to not be
So you get to pick from one of those skill tables there.
Mm-hmm.
Either personal development, service skills. If your education is high enough, advanced education, it has to be 8 or higher.
Nope.
Or dilettante. So personal development, service skills, or dilettante. And then you roll 1d6 and you get whatever you land on.
Oh, that's right. I'm looking at the Navy. I'm like, what? None of this looks the same.
There we go. Gunnery 3. What?
That doesn't make any sense. Personal development. I don't see a dilettante one. Oh. No.
The second row down, far on the right.
Oh, I see, yes. Do I get to choose which one I roll?
You choose on which of those 3 tables you roll. Personal development, service skills, or dilettante. And then you just roll a d6, and that tells you what skill you get.
I'll continue with the dilettante thing. I like this.
Okay.
What is that? So 3.
No, just 1d6.
Oh, sorry. I didn't listen. I wasn't listening. Cool. I'll reroll.
It's fine.
3. Flyer.
All right.
Oh, that's
gain
a skill?
The ability to fly in atmosphere aircraft.
Okay. At level 0?
At 1.
Oh, at 1? Oh.
Yeah, because you're getting these now at 1.
Nice.
Then you have to roll survival.
This is the one you want to miss if you want something interesting to happen.
Okay.
So an int roll of 8 plus.
With two dice?
Two dice, yes. Yeah.
Four, five. No, I may have failed.
All right.
She did not survive.
So you did not survive.
Roll 2d6 six times, start a new character. No. In the old days, that's when you would, that's when your character would die.
So now you roll 1d6 on the mishap table right here.
Okay.
And something's going to happen to you.
Oh, God.
Something terrible.
You just learned to fly. Something really bad could happen.
Political maneuverings usurp your position. Increase diplomat or advocate by one level and gain a rival.
Down with the oligarchy!
Right.
We totally went to the same college, and I've just been harboring a grudge.
Absolutely.
So plus one rival, and that was, what was it called? Political
maneuverings.
Political maneuverings.
Usurp my position.
And then you get to add one to either diplomat or advocate.
Yes.
Okay.
Cool.
Now, unless otherwise stated, you now have to leave your career as a dilettante.
Oh.
And then you get to roll for your benefits and mustering out.
Benefits and mustering out. Okay.
I need to find where that is in the book. Hold on. Thank you, Mongoose, for giving a searchable PDF.
The chat room saying that I passed that survival roll. Dilettante is social plus three plus.
No, that's to qualify.
I think.
Oh no! I'm sorry. You're totally right, everybody. Survival is social 3+. Advancement is int of 8+.
Oh, okay.
So that's I followed that up.
Okay.
So that was just a no, you didn't right, actually.
So you don't, you don't have a rival.
I don't have a rival,
and no political maneuvering.
Oh, that's kind of.
And
so I got my flying though, right?
You still got flying, and now you made your survival roll.
Okay.
See, this is kind of awesome to crowdsource intellect.
You guys doing it wrong.
Yay, chat room. We've been holding steady at 14. Oh, we're now at 15.
See? Awesome. Could be worse. All right, so you roll on the event table, 2d6.
Event table, 2d6.
Okay. The big one at the bottom.
8.
The same as before.
The same one.
Are you okay with rolling again?
We roll good.
Okay.
Unless you roll a 7.
No.
Well, yeah.
If you roll a 7, because that puts you on the
another
table.
Yeah.
Oh, no, I didn't. It was an 8 again.
Okay.
So now 6, 11. You make an alliance with a powerful and charismatic noble who becomes an ally. Either gain one level of leadership or DM plus 4 to your next advancement role, thanks to their aid. Ooh.
So you have to choose whether you want the skill or you want to make it easier to become an ingrate.
DM plus 4 next time.
An ingrate. That's awesome.
I know. I'm super excited about that title. The chat room's like, now when they mess up the rules, we don't just have to sit there and fume
openly.
So where's the chat room in... Is there a chat room in the YouTubes?
There is, but I don't know if it's streaming there. People are saying it says it is.
No, it is. Okay. It's there.
I think it started late, though, because when I started, it was still saying connecting. So I think we need to start streaming earlier so that there's, like, connection time or
something. Start the streaming with the logo for a while.
Yeah, for a while.
Maybe.
Oh, no, that's the test we did.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I don't know if it's actually there. It wasn't there. It's saying it's there, but then the people in the Twitch chat room are saying nope.
Well, let me check events.
Stu, will you put a cap on the number of terms?
Should we?
I don't know. There are negatives to trying to go beyond
that's
34.
True. That's true.
Automatically.
I don't know if we need to. I don't know if it's necessary.
Okay.
It's always funny when you get that one guy in the party that's like, I'm 64 years old. Right. I just got retirement.
That's why you have to have a mishap at the end.
Yeah.
Well,
why aren't you just living in a home?
If you make it to 65, I don't think you need a mishap. You just retire. Like, you just legit retire.
And this is what you want to do, whatever it is.
They say, nope, just looked again on the YouTube, still nothing. We have to figure out the restream.
I think the thing on YouTube is it has to be scheduled.
Oh, okay.
I think. I don't know if that's it.
All right.
But that
there's probably somewhere on the internet that has the answer to that question.
Maybe.
I would venture to guess you're correct. So you make your advancement roll. Let's finish that up. Your advancement roll is the int roll of 8 plus, mm-hmm. but you have 4
already.
Okay. And then is your int plus 1?
Yeah.
So you only need to roll a 3 or higher on the dice to make it. No pressure.
Okay. Oh yeah, I did. 11.
Rock on. So now you become an ingrate, and you gain an additional point of carouse.
All right. All right, my goal is met now. I am an ingrate.
Excellent.
That's sort of my goal.
At what's your carouse level now?
3? 2.
Oh, only 2.
Yeah.
That's still significant.
It is. Well, 3 is like, you're the best drinker on the planet.
Right, right. And then above that, it starts being like, you're the best drinker in the sector.
Yeah. Right. You're the Imperium's best drinker.
All right.
Back to me.
So that was advancement, and then you get to choose at this point whether you're going to continue as a dilettante or
I'll
leave.
I'll continue.
Okay.
I will continue as a dilettante.
Ta-da. So now it's back to Stu.
Okay.
With the book again. Navy.
Hand me the book again.
Yeah.
Give me the cup. Give me the cup. Give me the cup. All right. Navi. And I'm rolling. What am I doing? Oh, no, I just take a skill, right?
You choose which one you're going to roll, which category you want to roll in. You get a lot of stat boosts for personal development in the Navy.
Yeah. I'm going to go for advanced education because I have the high enough int. Oh, no.
Education.
Education. My education's 8.
So then you make it. Your favorite skill.
Administration.
You're in the Navy, man. 1. You gotta know how to do it.
All right. Then. What's the thing?
Then you roll for survival.
Survival. Flight. Oh.
You got 5, but you're +2 because you got the crazy dex.
Boom! 7. Made it exactly. Again!
Jeez. if commission is possible, do you want to try?
No.
Roll for advancement.
Education. Am I education good? Not good enough, but it's okay. Education. Bam! Look at that. Petty officer, second class.
You gain no skill.
I get a dash.
That's no skill.
Okay. Petty off. Tuned.
All right. Do you wish to continue in the Navy?
Indeed I do, sir.
A career Navyman. And that's it.
And I'm done.
Oh, did we do your event?
I didn't do an event.
We skipped that. Do an event.
Do an event. 4. You're given a special assignment or duty on board ship. Gain +1 DM to any one benefit roll.
So when you do leave, you get
I also have a +2 to a benefit roll for the Naval Academy. But I never got that. Do I lose that?
I don't know. I didn't read the Navy Academy part. Was there a...
I got an event, and it said good fortune, +2 to... +2 to 1 benefit roll.
I would assume that...
I don't know.
I'll look. All right. You look that up because you're done with that and it's my turn to...
Yeah, we'll do that way.
Yeah, you look that up and I...
So will. I got +1. That's my fourth term.
Yeah, well, college, and then one, two,
three, and third, yeah.
Three, yeah.
What was that again?
Okay.
Special assignment.
Here we go. So, I am going to roll my 1d6 on personal development. Two. I get int plus one.
Woo.
Okay. And then my event. No. Survival is an int of 7 plus. My int was it? It's still just plus 1.
Oh, holy metric.
Wrecked. I survive. And then I roll for my event. 9. That's the exact thing I got before. Rewarded for my diligence or cunning.
Want to roll again?
Yeah, I'll roll again. Right. What the heck? Add some spice to the life. 8. I learned something I should not have.
Ooh!
Uh-oh.
A corporate secret or political scandal, which I can profit from illegally. If I choose to do so, I gain plus 1 to a benefit roll and gain streetwise 1, deception 1, or a criminal contact. If I refuse, I gain nothing.
Excellent.
I am going to accept. I have now done something illegal in my life.
Read that to me one more time.
I learned something I should not have, a corporate secret or political scandal, which I can profit from illegally. If I choose to do so, I gain a plus 1 DM Benny roll. And then I get to pick streetwise 1, deception 1, or a criminal contact. If I refuse, I gain nothing. I'm gonna gain deception 1.
Okay. Do you have to make a roll to not get caught?
No.
Well, that sucks, because there's a whole prison career now.
Oh.
It doesn't say anything about that here.
Oh, well, poop. Okay, well, it looks like benefits, you get them regardless of why you leave. It says,
definitely
when you leave,
missed opportunity.
You're like very
right.
Moody right now on the mics. So you're very.
That's because my dog's leaning on the thing.
When you leave a career for any reason, you gain material benefits from that career representing money, equipment, and influence acquired during your years of work. There are two tables for this. In each career, cash and benefits. You may only roll on cash tables a maximum of 3 times in your lifetime, regardless of how many careers and benefit rolls you accumulate. You receive 1 benefit roll per term served. Leaving due to a mishap means you lose benefit roll for that term, but you still gain the benefit rolls for previous terms in that career. If you reach rank 1 or 2, you get an extra benefit roll when you leave that career. If you reach rank 3 or 4, you get 2 extra benefit rolls. If you reach rank 5 or 6, you get 3 extra benefit rolls, and you may also apply a DM of plus 1 to all rolls on cash and benefits tables. Benefits are described more fully on page 44.
But in the part about pre-career education, is there a benefits roll to like listed under military academy?
Everything's cool. It's fine.
No, but in the here, it said I get a plus 1 to the benefit. Is there going to find it? Unless it was in my second term that it happened.
Does it apply to your future career? Like, yeah, because I could see that making sense. Like, you get plus 1 to your benefit roll because you learned well.
Oh, no, it was I think I got a life event. And I rolled on the life event and it gave me that.
Okay.
I don't see it.
The first life event
it
I remember you getting
event.
Was the romantic relationship or something.
No. I think I had one before then, didn't I?
I really...
Naval Academy life event, good fortune.
Oh.
Plus 2 to the benefit role.
Oh, so...
Now, I don't know if there is one for military academy. Do I just make a Navy one, since it was a naval military academy?
Well, no. Well, when you leave the Navy, you will be able to use that plus 2 to one of your benefit roles.
Right.
Then, yeah. I just didn't know if there was a specific you left the military academy chart.
No, there isn't.
So then it just applies to whatever career you have later. You learn something gives you a little good fortune for down the road.
Right.
No problem. Cool. I didn't finish. I did my events. Now I'm going to try and roll to advance. And I don't. Right? I do! Oh. Thank heavens. I just made it. So I become a... rank 3.
Oh, it was a plus. Yeah, someone in the chat room says it's a plus 2 to any benefit roll.
Yeah.
Down the road, yeah. That's cool. So I'm now a rank 3 colonist with no new titles or skills.
It was not 65 outside. Today, right now, it's probably 80 outside.
No. We were talking about winters when Xander used to sit on my lap when we gamed outside. It was freezing. It was like 65.
It was colder than 65.
It was colder than 65. But that's not funny.
No. Right now, we're in monsoon weather.
Yeah.
It sucks.
It's gross. It's like Florida.
Yeah.
It's not quite.
No, totally.
Well, it is, except in Florida it would be like this all the time.
Yeah. All right.
I advanced. I'm going to stay as a colonist.
All right.
You're up.
All right.
Dilettante.
So, rolling dilettante on 1d6, right? No.
Yeah, 1d6 on, you, and you pick the dilettante chart.
Yes.
Okay.
Le table de dilettante.
6.
Jack of all trades.
Best skill ever.
All right.
You have jack of all. Do you get it at 1 or 0? 1.
Oh, okay. Nice.
Right? But I thought all these were at 1.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Yeah. So now you have every skill there is at 0.
No, at -1.
-1.
Still, good.
I think it used to be 0 in the old days.
Jack of all trades 0 meant negative.
Like it's negative.
No, yeah, negative 1. Yeah, 0.
Yeah, every skill at 0.
I'm gonna die. That's what's gonna happen next.
Or is it?
I don't know how it works. I'll read the. Oh, she has the book.
The chat room will tell us in a moment. Don't worry. All right. So I did that. So then I'm gonna stay as a dilettante. So I have to roll my survival.
Yes.
Is that still? I only have to get a 3 or whatever.
Yeah, it's super easy.
With 2d6.
This is McGillicuddy. Yes.
Ooh, 5, 6. Okay.
You really are trying to die.
All right. So I did not die.
Oh.
What?
It's -3 if you don't have a skill.
So then it's 0 is 2, 1 is neg 1. Is that
negative 2.
What is
if the traveler has jack of all trades 2, the penalty is reduced by 2.
So it's -1. If it starts out at -3.
Starts out at -3. Yeah, if you get all the way to jack of all trades 3, you can negate the penalty for being unskilled.
Okay.
Okay.
So yeah, you get it at 1.
So at 1, you're at -2.
2 to everything.
Okay. That's still better.
As opposed to -3.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right.
Why are you telling me I purchased this product when it doesn't show up in my...
Is it the shag rugs?
No.
Okay.
Oh, it's the book for this game. Book.
Oh, okay.
It says, you have purchased this product.
Okay.
Like, yeah. That's great.
So you made your survival roll.
So I made my survival roll.
Okay, cool. Now you roll event.
Event.
2d6.
2d6. 5. I inherit a gift from a rich relative. Gain DM +1 to any one benefit roll.
There you go.
So do I make a benefit roll?
No.
Only when you leave the
make
career.
A note of a benefit.
Okay. Yeah, you want to jot down that you get +1
okay.
to a benefit roll. That's how, on the mustering out benefits,
mm-hmm.
you'll see it goes all the way up to 7. So if you use that +1 and you rolled a 6, you get whatever the 7th one is.
Okay.
So it's pretty awesome. Okay.
I wonder if it's telling me that I have the book because I ordered the print-on-demand book.
And you don't have the PDF? I don't know. Because when I bought the PDF package, it came with like five PDFs that I put into my PDF library.
I don't remember that.
Like it came with like the pop-out for this as a separate PDF.
Oh, and really?
It came
okay.
with the pop-out for like the ship maps.
Oh, okay. I don't think I have that. I don't think I have that.
So you had your event, you inherited something, then mm-hmm. you, if you wish to try to advance.
Sure, I can't die, right? I'm really scared of dying at this point. I really like my character.
Dying isn't a thing okay. anymore.
Okay, good.
But something bad could happen.
But I'd still be the character. Like, I'd just be a character with a bad thing to happen. So it'd be more interesting.
Well, no, on an advancement roll, nothing bad can happen.
Okay.
Worst case scenario, you just don't advance.
Okay.
Yeah. Right. No, there's no bad downside to trying.
All right, advancement roll.
So that's the int roll of 8 plus.
7 plus 1, 8.
Then you made it. So now you are a rank 3 ingrate.
You're an ingrate!
Even better ingrate!
If you advance one more time, you become the black sheep.
I know. How old? But I'm like super old now, right?
Well,
you could, you know, you could still be a black sheep and be old.
Oh, yeah. No.
Yeah, yeah.
Especially
creepy uncle or creepy aunt.
Your family has a lot of longevity.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. Look at the British royal family.
Right. But, like, how old am I now?
4 years for each career. So, okay. College was 4 years. That's
mm-hmm.
22.
Mm-hmm.
4 years for the first one. That's 26. 30, 34.
Okay, so I'm 34 now.
So that's still totally way young enough to be the black sheep of a family.
Oh, yeah.
Absolutely.
Or to be an ingrate.
Absolutely.
Especially in space future time, your parents are totally alive.
Yeah.
Like, they're not.
Word. Bless you.
I tried to cover up the microphone.
You did. That helped a lot. Because if you don't, it's like...
Starting a leaf blower. All right.
Oh, yeah, it does come up with a lot of stuff.
And then you choose, or if you're going to try and continue as a dilettante, but I believe we should look now at aging.
I'm out. Fuck aging rolls. I ain't doing aging rolls. I'm out. Unless it's too late, they'll make one.
At the end of your fourth career term...
You have to make an aging roll?
You have to make an aging roll.
Shit stains.
So, we should all do that. You roll 2d6 on the aging table. And you use your number of terms as a negative dice modifier.
Oof. Table.
So, well, I've got it right here. So if you just roll, I'll tell you. Page 47.
I just want to see it. I'm going to die.
It's not super bad. Because you have to be... Like, right now, we're at -4 to our die roll.
Mm-hmm.
And you have to get into negative numbers before things start happening that are bad.
Right.
So
reduce 3 physical characteristics by 2. Reduce 1 mental characteristic by 1. That's one of the results you can
get. That's if you get to -6.
Yes.
Which is impossible at this point.
That's true.
I'm Booyah!
I rolled a 10.
Fuck.
Did you roll a 2? He did!
You really rolled a 2?
Yeah.
So 2.
So you're at -2. You reduce 3 physical characteristics by 1.
Okay.
You can't. Okay. You're in your 30s now. You can't be drinking super hard like you were
when
you
were 18,
Ms. Drummer. Because you're not British. You're not like Keith Richards.
Well, no, he's on analgesics. Or what are they called? Anagathics?
Anagathics.
Analgesics. Took aspirin. I took a lot of aspirin.
He rubs creams all over himself.
That's what gives him that nice complexion.
Now, do you want to include anagathics as a thing or no?
Nah, I don't know if they would be around. They might be, but I don't think so.
Well, let me read it real quick. At the start of a career term, a traveler can take anagathics by rolling a social roll of 10+. If you roll a 2 exactly, you go to prison.
Okay, yeah, I totally.
While using anagathic drugs, the traveler effectively does not age. add the number of terms since the traveler started taking them as a positive DM on the aging table. If the traveler stops taking them for any reason in the future, you have to roll immediately on the aging table as the shock of the system beginning to age strikes again. And agathics have two drawbacks. First, the combined risk of trying to obtain a reliable supply, and the disruption of biochemistry means the traveler must make two survival checks in each term instead of one. If either or both survival checks are failed, the traveler suffers a mishap. Second, the drugs cost one die times 200,000 credits for each term the traveler uses these drugs. These costs are paid out of traveler's eventual cash benefits. If the traveler cannot pay these bills, they go into debt. See medical debt on page 49. Or in America. A medical debt after you've finished creating your traveler, but before your campaign begins, you have to pay outstanding costs from medical care or anagathic drugs out of your benefits. Any debt left over is hanging over you at the start of the game and will sure to be collected, likely with interest. So, it's up to you if you want them in or not.
Oh, sure. As long as if there's a chance of someone rolling and going to prison for it, yeah.
Then yes, his whole goal is for someone to get on the prison table.
I want to receive a prison roll. But I'm out.
You're retiring.
I did one more age roll than I usually ever do.
Okay.
Because I know aging sucks. Far too accurate.
So is dilettante something you'd wash out of too? Like, I guess everybody has to wash out of their thing.
Well, you're going to retire eventually. Like, okay. Let's just keep going until we decide all of us want to be finished with careers.
Okay. I think I want to be finished with careers.
Okay. So that's cool. I'm going to go again.
All right.
I'm not taking the drugs.
Greedy Dave.
That's how I roll.
Greedy boy.
No, I just want to... I have a chance to get... If I go up one more rank, I get to be an explorer and not just a settler. So I could be like the Magellan of Proxima Centauri.
Exactly.
That's awesome.
You're right.
Ponce de la Douche.
That's what they'll call you. There they are. Now I have the book here. Bless you.
Sorry. All right. Here we go. So I'm going to roll on personal development.
Five golden rings.
I got a four. I learned how to gamble.
All right. That's probably how we met.
You came to play a gig on Proxima Centauri. Huh? Okay. Which we do need to work out. Because we've all kind of heard what has happened to each other as we go, so we should talk out after we finish.
Well, we should probably wait until we get the rest of the people in the game, too.
Yeah. That's not a bad idea. Just have everybody keep pretty detailed notes about what's happening event-wise, and then we can all talk about it. Then I'm going to see if I survive. Owned! Yeah, sweet. So I survived. I'm going to roll my event. Six. I'm given advanced training in a specialist field. Roll education 10+ to gain any skill of my choice at level 1.
Oh, jeez. What else would you pick?
I don't think Jack of all trades is something that they give you special training in. Like, here's how to do everything.
It's any skill.
Well, if you say that's okay, but I wouldn't have picked that.
Okay, that's fine. Pick whatever you want.
Yeah, fine. You take my dice and go home.
Traveler. Oh, printer-friendly version. Thank you, Mongoose.
Yeah, that's the black and white one that I'm looking at. Because it loads way faster. PDF.
Oh, there's an e-book. Oh, no, that's just a regular thing. I thought it was like an e-book format. That would be fantastic.
Well, you could easily load this on an e-reader because it's totally...
Right. Yeah, yeah.
They've taken out everything but...
Oh, okay.
The, like, you know...
Right.
Even the pages that have big art, they have, like, just a big X.
Oh, it's just like the playtest version. It had a lot of that in it.
Okay. Two I have to make an education roll of 10+. Let's see. I do! I got a 9, and I'm +1 on my education. So I get... plus one to any skill. Advanced training.
There's a yatched
event. Okay. Then I'm going to roll to advance. I love how the advancement for a colonist is just live. Just right. Live long enough and you advance.
Mm-hmm.
I got a 5. Perfect. So I become an explorer.
Right, so.
Do you get a skill for that?
I do. I get navigation 1.
Mm-hmm.
All right, they're all having streaming issues at the moment. So oh, I don't really? Know if the kids started. Are they in bed?
No, they're asleep.
Okay.
Yeah, they all went to bed. Now, I downloaded the Traveler book.
Probably.
But I'm done.
Well, they're lagging a little, so.
Oh, okay. I wouldn't think that would affect up at all.
Oh, it totally does on cable.
It shouldn't. I have 60 down and 4 or 5 up.
Yeah, but.
It's a tube.
An inefficient tube. All right.
Is your Dropbox syncing or something?
No.
Okay. So that was that. I advanced.
Oh, no, it is syncing, yeah.
That's probably it. Oh, you know why? That stuff to Dropbox.
It might be. It's almost done, though.
Okay. And then I'm retiring.
Can I pause it?
Yeah.
Yes, I can pause it. Got to make sure I unpause it.
Okay. But I need to make an aging roll. That was page 47, right?
Yep.
And I've been through 5 turns.
5, so minus 5.
Where did my other die go?
5.
Oh.
5? Minus 5? 1 and a what? Did you roll 2 ones?
No, I got 3. I got 4. Three. So I'm a negative 1. I reduce 2 physical characteristics by 1.
Oh, that's good.
Not bad.
That's what you get. Well, you're an oldie. Everyone's done?
Yeah.
Mishaps.
Do we get to roll benefits, though?
Oh, she can do that first if we want.
Oh, no.
Well, we can just do our mishaps.
Yeah, let's do mishaps.
That's not going to affect the benefits.
Mm-mm.
No.
We all made it out safely. We know that.
Do the English keep the E in aging?
Yes.
Hmm. That looks very wrong.
That looks strange.
They do. I mean,
do they really?
Yeah, I it's there. I'm assuming.
I think
it was
so.
Proofread. It's bolded and it's in like 18 point type. I'm sure someone would have noticed it. It's there twice.
Hmm.
And it's in the title too, and I would imagine it's spelled that way everywhere.
Hmm.
Just seems very strange to me.
Mm-hmm.
So, we're just rolling on the mishap table for our last career, yeah?
Yeah, I'm trying to find the mishap table.
It's on your Navy page, whatever that page is. You're past it.
Oh.
There you go.
I was expecting a big, huge...
No, it's just 1d6.
During battle, defeat or victory depends on your actions. You must make an 8+ roll using the a skill that depends on your branch. Electronics or gunner if you are crew, mechanic, and pilot or tactics if you are flight. I have pilot. If you fail, the ship suffers severe damage and you are blamed for the disaster. You are court-martialed and discharged. Oh. If you succeed... Oh, these are all bad.
I know.
This is the bad thing that puts you in... Yeah. If you succeed, your efforts ensure that you are honorably discharged. You still leave your career, but you may keep your benefit roll from this term. But we've already all gotten out.
Yeah.
So I need to make 8+ piloting. So my piloting is 1, so I need a 7 or higher. Bam! Made.
Honorable discharge.
Honorably discharged.
Nice.
It was just a shit show. You did the best you could.
Right.
That tug pilot shouldn't have been there.
Almost wrecked my ship.
Tell me it was like a big destroyer. But, so, you know, like big.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, sure. Yeah. Light cruiser.
Mm-hmm. You're that guy that, like, didn't slow down and just went right into a dock.
Right.
Like that cruise ship recently, right?
Oh, no. I didn't see that.
That, like...
That's expensive.
Yeah, like $8 or $10 million because it wrecked this whole dock.
What did it do to the ship?
Oh. Not much. It was like a glancing blow, but it just ripped this whole dock asunder.
Oh.
So that guy that decided to go buzz central France and he beached the boat. Don't you remember that was a big cruise ship?
Oh, the like Costa Concordia or whatever.
Yeah. That's
it was there for
show.
Like a year and a half.
Oh yeah, yeah. They ended up putting like big balloons sacks or something underneath it to kind of get the right. Yeah,
I saw the pictures when it came up. That half was all algae covered, and
of course it was.
Yeah, I know, but it was interesting because the top half was still gorgeous and clean. So one half looked fine, and the other half it was like.
So depending on which direction, it was like a ghost ship.
It was like Two-Face.
The all right. Ship. So nobility. You were the noble?
Yep. Yeah.
Let's see. 1d6.
1d6.
All right. 5.
5? An assassin attempts to end your life. Roll end plus 8. If you fail, roll on the injury table.
Oh, no.
Assassino.
2 dice.
2d6. 2 dice.
Do I get the plus?
What's your end?
Your endurance.
No, it's 5.
So is it negative 1?
Minus 1. So you need a 9 or higher.
9 or... fuck.
You can do it.
No, God!
Oh my God, you rolled 2!
Again! This is the worst night ever! Oh my God! I'm switching out dice.
You have to roll on the injury table.
We're done. Where's the injury table, I wonder?
I think it's with...
Oh, here it is. 1d6.
Different dice.
Just 1.
Yeah. 2.
Severely injured. Reduce 1 physical characteristic by 1d.
Oh, so roll another d6.
Oh, what? By 1d? Oh, fuck. Oh. 2. Well,
that could be a lot worse. So right. One of your physical characteristics has to go down by 2.
7, okay.
Dude, that's brutal.
That's super brutal.
But you survived. You didn't get killed. So okay. Make sure make a note that someone has tried to assassinate you.
Does it say like specifically what got hurt?
No. Okay. It's up to you. It could be a back injury. I mean, it could be anything.
And so how old am I?
Sciatica.
Yeah. So I'm still 34 though. If I was 34, yes. In the okay.
Yeah. This didn't count for that. All right. Now let's see what my citizen colonist mishap is going to be.
Citizen.
Here we go. Here we go. 3. Hard times caused by lack of interstellar trade cost me my job. Oh. Lose 1 social. Now social 3.
All right. Lost job.
Hard.
Minus 1 sock.
Lost job. Minus 1 system on chip. All right. So now, the mustering out part.
Yes. You want to do yours first since I got the book up here?
Well, yeah, but what's the number of rolls again? What page was that on? You looked it up before?
What do you mean?
But the benefits rolls? You looked up
You get one per turn. Oh, no, you get more than that. It's more complicated than that.
Yeah,
that's right.
Like one per turn, and then you get extra for being in different ranks. And
okay. There are 2 tables. Blah, blah, blah. You receive 1 benefit roll for each full term.
So that's 5.
Leaving due to a mishap means you lose the benefit roll for that term that hasn't happened.
None of us.
But you still gain the benefit rolls for the previous terms. Okay. If you reach rank 1 or 2, get 1 extra roll. If you reach rank 3 or 4, you get 2 extra benefit rolls. You can never roll more than 3, was it 3 times total?
3 times on cash.
On the cash. If you get a 5 or 6, you get 3 extra benefit rolls and may also apply DM plus 1 to all rolls on the cash and benefits table. Benefits are described more fully on page 44.
None of us got that.
No. I got rank three, I think. Or four. What did I get? Three?
I got to four. Three and four is the same, though. You get two.
I get to rank three.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I got five rolls and then two for my rank. You got four rolls and two for your rank.
Right.
And Kimmy, you got four rolls and two for your rank.
Okay.
So I get six total.
Six total for each of you, and I got seven total. But you can't roll more than three times on the cash list.
Okay.
You can purposely choose to roll less than three on the cash list.
Right.
If you want.
Well, what? I guess, yeah.
Well, because sometimes the stuff on the other side is truly valuable.
Okay.
Ship share.
Hmm.
Two ship shares. Gun. Because with a gun, you can get more cash.
Yeah.
Anytime you need.
Especially in travel. All right. You want to roll, Dave?
Sure. I will roll on the cash.
Okay.
Four. 10,000 credits.
And I kind of miss that they don't call it mustering out anymore.
Yeah.
They still call it mustering out.
Benefits.
Well, it says mustering out benefits.
Oh, it does. Oh, it didn't say that in the other section. It just said benefits.
10K. All right. I'll do cash again. Shit. 10K. You know what? All three on cash.
There you go.
Fuck. 5K. And now I get four rolls on benefits. Two. I got an ally.
Write that down.
Four. I got a gun. With no skills to use it. Five. Education. Plus one.
Ooh. You mustered out with a book.
I get one more roll, right?
Mm-hmm.
Six, one more. Come on, six. Big six. Big six.
Oh, two ship shares.
I got two. I got another ally.
Plus one ally.
Okay. I'm not destitute, and I have some friends. And a gun.
El Noble.
This is where you're like, oh, I rolled a three. I got 400,000 credits.
It's not quite that ridiculous, but it's pretty ridiculous.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, yeah. Now, you get a plus two.
Oh, crap. One of mine was supposed to be plus one.
Well, which one?
Pick one. It'll be fine.
Or you can just re-roll your last one.
It was the one I rolled a four, because then I got 40,000 credits instead of 10,000 credits.
Okay.
Sorry, what
so you get to
two?
You also get a bonus, right?
Did Probably.
You, didn't you get one?
Oh, yeah. No, I got a plus one to one benefit roll.
Okay. All right.
So roll two.
And tell me which one you want to add it to.
I will.
You can roll up to three times on the cash table, and then there's the benefits table.
Can I see the benefits table?
Yeah.
That will help me make a wise decision.
This is where, if she keeps rolling on the benefits table and keeps getting fours, she could end up at, like, social 16.
Right.
Where's the benefits table? Rank?
On the other side.
Right under
you got it
career
right there.
Progress, mustering out benefits.
First, oh, got it.
First page,
it.
Second column, okay. Halfway down. Hmm.
What is TAS membership?
Traveler's Aid Society.
It's like the Interstellar Auto Club.
Do I have to say before I roll it, or can I roll and then pick?
You have to say, which column table you're rolling in first.
You should also say which one you're adding.
Yeah, don't be
I'll
like
do
me.
I'll do benefits for the first one.
Okay.
And remember, you have a DM.
It'll be plus one, right?
But you have to say you're using it before you're going to do it.
Right.
I think, I don't know if it was plus one or what, if it was
It was plus one.
Okay.
I'll just use it right off the gate.
All right. On
benefits plus one. I won't use that dice. That dice was mean.
Big money.
Five, six.
Oof. 200K.
A yacht.
A yacht.
Oh, a yacht. You got a mansion and a yacht.
Oh, yeah. So I have a yacht. Go yacht. Yay.
There's your ship. You want to call it Ashes of Exodus?
That seems super emo, like something I'd probably name it.
You were like super...
Or we can name it Exodus, and then it's just like, oh no.
And it crashes and burns in the first episode. And we're all just on a planet like, ta-da! What the fuck? Space.
All right, so I get to roll three times, you said?
You get to three times.
Six
on
total
the
rolls.
Oh, six total rolls.
Only three can be for cash. For
cash, okay.
But you've used one now, so five.
So I have a yacht.
That's the best thing you could have gotten.
That's totally the best thing.
Well, no, you could have gotten, if you'd rolled a six and you used your plus one, you would have ended up with social plus one and a yacht.
Yeah, that would have been the best. But whatever, I'll take that.
Could be slightly better, but it's still all
right. Right. I will take... I'll do cash this
just
time.
Just a dram.
Two. Credit, 10,000 credits, I guess.
Yep.
I'll do benefits again. Six.
Another yacht.
Another yacht. Yeah.
Aye, aye, Commodore.
All right, so we have a fleet.
I think it'll give you like equivalent value in money.
Okay.
Probably.
Okay.
We'll look that up in the.
Yes.
Okay. All right. So there's three rolls. I'll do one more on money. Three. So 50,000.
Or you might have the second yacht that is being leased out to someone, and it's a steady source of income.
I like that. That's a good idea. I'll do the benefits again. Right? You said six times, right?
You get six total rolls. Okay.
But only three can be on cash.
Yeah. No, yeah. Okay.
She hasn't done any of that yet. So.
No, I've done two cash. I've done two cash rolls.
I missed the second cash roll. I'm sorry.
Yeah. So I have 60K now, plus two yachts.
Oh. A mansion and a yacht.
All right, so I'll do your benefits again this time.
I'm a J. Fudd, emo millionaire. I own a mansion and a yacht.
Two. So I have two ship shares.
Two additional ship shares?
Yeah.
Great.
No, she owns two yachts and ship shares for something else.
Like a cargo hauler.
I want them in a card game. And I'll do my last one for cash.
That's the best. You want them in a card game and you don't even know what they're for. You're right. Like, I've got these.
Money shows up.
When I need it, it's there.
There's dividends. I don't know where I get them from.
10K again. Bummer.
Page 44.
All right.
So two yachts, 70K, and two ship shares.
All right. I'm rolling. I'm going to roll three times on the... Yeah. On the... I've got it here.
Oh, okay.
On the Navy cash table. I'm going to cash... I have a couple of pluses. I'm going to use my plus two for my first cash roll, which is a good idea because I rolled a one. So I got 5K. Ooh, 5,000 big ones.
Oh, shit.
Aww.
What?
Well, I can recalculate this.
Okay.
What happened?
We should have read in the additional information on benefits area.
Uh-oh.
A traveler with the gambler skill. Did you get gambler skill?
I didn't.
Okay. Gets plus one DM to all rolls on the cash column.
Oh, you can recalculate.
Yeah. Redo that.
That's easy enough to do.
I don't have gambling. Two more times on that. Cash, five. 20,000.
46.
That's now 25,000. One more on said table. I'm going to use my plus one. Four, 10,000. So I have 35,000 credits. And then my other stuff. Four, a weapon.
It's worked out for what happens with your yacht, if that's what you're reading.
Yeah.
So since you got yacht twice, it's half paid off.
Oh, okay.
Each time you get that on your thing, it's 25% of the mortgage on that ship.
Oh.
Oh, okay. Paid. All right.
I see.
Three. Education plus one or two ship shares. What's the DM change? When does the DM change? At nine for education?
I'm nine taking goes to plus one.
Education plus one because I now have a nine. Plus one. And then one more. Five, Travelers Aid Society membership.
Okay. So here's a spare character that people can use if they want to come in and play ad hoc. John Casey Biggins.
Hey!
Navy pilot.
I made it long enough as a colonist, I get a pension.
Oh, excellent. Nice.
10,000 credits a year. Oh, yes.
Do they get that in sheep?
I assume that it is paid that way, but then I sell them, and that's how I get the money.
Right.
10,000, yeah.
Excellent.
Okay. I would assume that a sheep on a foreign planet is probably expensive.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. Assuming it has something to eat.
Right. Well, all of the science fiction stuff is idealized on the idea that, like, our microbiome can exist elsewhere.
Right.
Yeah.
So how much are the ship shares worth? It says they're worth roughly 1 million credits.
Then they're worth roughly 1 million credits.
Right, but you can't really trade it for money. But how does that work towards, like, ownership of my yacht? If I already own 50% of my yacht.
Well, let's look at page 186. I'll get there. Just hang out there on there.
Now, the High Guard book has shipbuilding in it now?
I don't know.
I think there's no shipbuilding in this book.
Okay.
Anymore. What so page one what?
The page 186 is the yacht.
It may not be that yacht, though, because that it's probably is it a jump one yacht?
Yes.
Oh, it is. Okay.
Yeah. The yacht, for example, costs a mega credit is 1 million, right?
Yes.
Costs 60 million credits.
Okay. Okay.
So if half is paid off,
you owe 30.
You owe 30, and then ship shares would knock an additional one off of that.
Okay. Maybe I should just keep the ship shares as something separate from someone else's ship.
As some other ship.
That I, like, get income from. To help me with the mortgage. Okay. That way, if we have a dry spell of work, I have steady income.
See, that's a Tech 12 yacht, though. We're going to have to design that.
Right. But according to character creation, this is
a yacht.
Yeah. So you could lower the tech a little bit, but you don't want to lower the ship.
No. I wouldn't lower the ship, but it probably is not going to have, because the thing is that jump one drive, depending how they made this, I haven't done ship creation since Old Traveler, but if it had the jump one drive that's tech level 12 is a smaller drive than a jump one drive that's tech level 10.
Chat room says, yes, High Guard has shipbuilding. And they asked where you got the print-on-demand copy.
Because you don't see an Android copy.
That was from the, was it a Kickstarter? Mm. No, it was through Drive-Thru RPG, but it was the preview, you know, you paid money for
the beta?
Yeah, it was for the beta test version of the game, and they sent you a coupon for X number off on the
book.
But I've noticed when I was just looking in here, it's not available. You can't buy the print-on-demand book, but that's where it came from.
Mm. Sorry.
Hopefully they'll have it again. Maybe they're not doing that to support local gaming stores, because they had a copy of it at Game Empire.
Mm.
Well, it may be a thing that, like, they're planning to sell it as a PDF, but they're actually printing copies to get out there.
Maybe.
So they don't want competition from online printing.
Right. It could be.
Kind of a thing.
But yeah, that's where it came from, was that because I was on the playtest.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. But there's 12 staterooms in your yacht.
Nice.
It may end up being like 11, depending on how much larger the jump drive is. I'll get
this. This is a jump one.
Yeah, but a Tech 12 jump one drive might be a lot smaller than a Tech 10 jump. That's what
fine. I'm saying. I'll make it with just 11 staterooms.
But the nice part is that means that there's actually room for, like, all of the players.
There's
in the game.
Like crew quarters, right? So I don't have to use my 11 staterooms.
That's
on the
usually
crew?
Usually the staterooms, but they also you might also have.
There is
low...
a luxury stateroom.
Oh, that's
in addition to the 12.
Oh,
okay.
That would be like the owner's.
There's
suite.
Probably low passage berths as well, aren't there? There aren't.
No.
They usually show them in engineering if they have them.
They're not.
Is there empty space on the deck where they can, like, have a cot?
Sleep.
No, low berth, they're not even awake.
Low berth is like hypersleep.
Oh, yes, hypersleep. Yeah. Okay, yeah. I remember that. I'm so excited we're playing this game.
It's a very fun
game. But it has a ship's boat.
Yeah, I almost rolled a ship's boat. That would have been nice. Highgard?
Mm-hmm.
That's the book I'm looking for.
Yeah, Stu, they have Highgard open in the chat room. What would you like to know about the jump drive?
Well, does the size of the drive change?
The tonnage?
The tonnage change from tech level, jump one drive from tech 10 to 12. That's what I need to know. I'm actually going to go ahead and get the Highgard book right now. Because I will need
it. Since I threw everything off and own a ship.
Oh, that's fine.
I know.
You guys are going to have a ship anyway.
Yeah. It wasn't going to be probably this nice, but.
It's exactly the same ship we had in the other Traveler.
Is it?
It is. Oh.
Well.
Because Dave rolled an Archduke.
Mine was all, like, not nearly half paid off, though.
No.
That was the problem.
That and someone had tried to assassinate you. And you'd gained an enemy.
Yeah, my enemy was... No, I was a duke, and I'd made an enemy of an archduke.
No, you were an archduke.
No. Because archduke is one step away from the emperor.
You are an I specifically remember, you were an archduke. I think you were. No,
I was a duke, just a plain duke. Because that was the thing, because I rolled on my mishap, you've made an enemy of a social superior, and you're like... So you made... And you were like,
The emperor? No.
Yeah. So you made it...
See, because I think... I seem to remember that we decided not to make it the emperor, because that's all it could be, so we said it was a rival archduke.
Oh, maybe.
That's why I think you were an archduke.
I just remember the enemy was an archduke.
Yeah, because we had figured out, like, your father is the archduke over this sector over here that was, like... I don't remember which sector it was. The rept sector or something.
Yeah.
And so you were basically were on the run.
I'd assume there is some kind of crew... State, because they're listed, there's a pilot, an astrogator, an engineer, a medic, and a steward.
Right.
Well, so there would have to be somewhere for crew to sleep.
I'm sure it's staterooms. They probably double up or something.
I have steward training. So I could be the steward.
There you go. But I think everyone who makes a character is basically going to be a member of the crew. But now you need to figure out why it is the ship is out and what it is you're doing. Because what we don't want to have is the typical, we're just trying to get by and make money so we can make our ship payments.
Well,
that will be part of it.
The plus side is that, yay, there's a yacht in the group. Cool. It's not like it has guns.
No.
Like, like how I proposed earlier, the idea of, like, we're privateers.
Right.
We're privateers where we trick people into coming on board for a ride and then we rob them and leave them somewhere else. I suppose we could do that.
You could. You could actually operate that way for a while before word spread at the speed of travel. But I don't know if you would...
And the maintenance cost of the yacht is 5,065 credits per month.
Not including fuel, or does that include fuel?
It just says maintenance cost.
Okay.
You better make fucking money.
The yacht is a noble's plaything, used to entertain friends and undertake political or commercial missions. The staterooms are all well-appointed, but even they fail to make the grade in comparison to the luxury stateroom attended for the yacht owner. The yacht carries an air raft and a ship's boat with thin docking compartments. An ATV is also carried, with the ship's boat being used to ferry it from orbit to the surface and back again.
Air raft, you never use the air raft. You have to put on a vac suit to use an air raft.
Oh, okay.
Unless you're in atmosphere. Now, is that streamlined? You can go in the atmosphere? It should say streamlined somewhere under the hull.
Yeah, I know, but there's like lots of stats, so I don't see streamlined.
Oh, really?
The ship's boat is.
Okay.
You could attach the air raft to the ship's boat.
Well, you can, usually air rafts is the poor man's ship's boat.
Right. It's the equivalent of Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom.
Yes.
The ship comes close to the atmosphere and you jump in this little inflatable thing and it falls.
Right.
And then you skid on the mountain.
Right. Okay.
All right. It appears that a Jump 1 engines in a TL-9 device, and is 2.5% of the hole. And there's not further info on the chart, so presumably it doesn't get smaller. So page 14 of Highguard.
Okay. Well, I'll sit down. Now, I believe Highguard, I just got it. I believe that has the ship building rules. Mm-hmm. I will make a tech TL-10 yacht.
Okay.
And according to that, those rules. And we'll see
it did say in the character creation that we have to roll once on the old ship rules.
Oh, excellent.
What does that mean?
Because you might have a jalopy.
Well, it is somewhat used in some way. Because almost all ships are, yeah. Like, unless you're incredibly rich.
Probably not.
There's the layout for the yacht.
Nice.
Brilliant.
That's right. The yacht we had. Oh my gosh, the Duke.
Yeah.
The goat. Goat. I still have my little goat. He's in my cosplay shop. The goat. Oh my god.
I felt so bad.
The goat. Murdered goat. Oh my god. Goats are like a theme with our games. Have you noticed? So now we have
sparkle goats. You're right.
Jupiterian sparkle goats.
I can't wait to join up.
I'm so excited about that.
Because I made like the guy that fits in with. Because you guys haven't left
Jupiter.
Like the last episode was still the one where you like just had your fight with the sparkle goats, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
Good.
And they have to try to get them back.
I will ride mine triumphantly. Maybe not immediately. It might take a little while.
So there is in the public spaces of the yacht. There's a theater.
Oh.
There's a dining room and a kitchen, a gym, a salon, and a computer room.
All right.
There is a crew common area. That is separate from the passenger common area.
Cool.
So, like, there is a... The crew has their own rooms. But let me see...
Not their own rooms, but something like they have their own, like, mess.
Two, four, five. Yes, and five of the 12 staterooms are set for crew.
Okay. And the ship shares, I need to figure out how much money I make off of those.
You'll have to kind of figure it out, I don't know.
Yeah.
Well, they're worth about 1 million credits.
Right. So how does that translate into monthly income?
Depends on what kind of profit the ship's making. I would imagine we'll have to sit down and figure out what it is.
Okay. Cool.
Or you could just knock $2 million off the mortgage for this ship.
I think I'd rather have steady income. Because $2 million off 30 million is not 30, huge.
28.
Yeah. Right, but
if I owed $28 million or $30 million, I really don't know if I'd know the difference.
Well, you know the difference when it comes to a monthly amount you owe breakdown.
I don't think I could pay either.
Well, yes. Yes, but they also wouldn't have given you that kind of a loan at this point either.
Might as well have asked for 40.
Right. That's what I'm saying. They're, like, she's already gotten past the, I'm actually qualified to get this kind of a loan to get a ship. I made a 50% down payment. Right.
All right. I think we're done. Right. And do you guys have character names?
No.
I'm going to figure that out now.
I will figure that
mold
out.
Mull that over?
And
yeah.
All right.
That's always the hardest part for me.
All right.
I have to look all up right. Like early socialists.
Trotsky? How early you want to go?
Well, like, not famous Soviets.
Engels?
Yeah, I don't know. We'll see.
He's British, right?
Yeah, I think.
Be a Luddite.
No, because I have tech skills. Like yeah, computer skills.
Saying how to break things.
I'm the Luddite secret agent on the space yacht.
Right.
The camera's not working in the theater again.
Hmm.
Is problem.
I guess we'll have to read books.
It should have been. Because the Centauri accent can work again.
Yes, it can.
Can keep working. All right, good.
So, who are we before we go?
thank you for joining us. This is the character generation session for
Ashes of Exodus.
Ashes of Exodus.
Their Mongoose Traveller
game, which will start
soon,
shortly
in the future.
Dun dun dun.
And we'll have other, if other people want to make characters to join the ad hoc game.
Yep, check our live stream schedule, and you will eventually see it there.
And don't forget to join us on Saturday at 10:30 a.m. Pacific time for Happy Jacks RPG Podcast Season 17, Episode 17?
Something.
I believe.
Sure.
I think so.
Sounds right.
And that will happen at happyjacks.org/live. We'll have all the links.
Yeah.
That's it.
Cool.
Very awesome.
All right.
I'm gonna do the New Media Empire thing.
Okay.
Do you have the little tourney thing up?
Yes.
The preceding program has been a presentation of the Angry Folk Media Empire. Bum, 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 bum.